Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I would like us to get settled. We are about to start. It's going to be a great night. I want you to tell your neighbor you are welcome in the name of Jesus. Say it as you mean it. Say, neighbor. Say, you are welcome. Say, neighbor. Say, you are welcome in the name of Jesus. Say, tonight will be a great night. I feel it that way. This is the first time we are having our Holy Ghost service at 7 p.m., right? So that means there's something special about tonight. And tonight is designed to be a blessing to you. I want you to be excited. I want you to open up your spirit, because God is going to do something great. God is going to do something great. You are wonderful. You are worthy, oh Lord. You are wonderful. You are worthy, oh Lord. We say
you are wonderful.
You are worthy, name we pray. I want you to put Psalm 106 verse 1. Psalm 106 verse 1. If you have your Bible, you can open it. If it's not there on the screen, Psalm 106. Hallelujah, somebody. If you are there, shout hallelujah. I want us to read verse 1 as a church. 1, 2, go. Praise ye the Lord. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endureth forever. Hallelujah. Did you see that? He said, oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endureth forever. Now flip your Bible to the next chapter, 107 verse 1. Just turn it to the next chapter of Psalm 107 verse 1. Verse 1. And I would like us to read together again. 1, 2, go. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good. His mercy endureth forever. Hallelujah, somebody. God is a merciful God. We are here today because his mercy endureth forever. So I'd like you to open your mouth and give thanks. The psalmist said, oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good. So it's time to appreciate God for his goodness. It's time to appreciate God for his mercy. God is a good God. God has been good to you. God has been good to your family. God has been good to your children. God has been a good God. Thank him for his goodness. Thank him because his mercy endured forever over your life, over your family. Oh, a lot of people saw this year. A lot of people are no more this year. A lot of people that are still alive, some of them are in the hospital. Thank God you are not in the hospital. You are in the sanctuary this hour. You are not in the mortuary. You are in the sanctuary. So open your mouth and give thanks. Open your mouth and give thanks for his goodness. Open your mouth and give thanks for his mercy endured forever. He's merciful to you. He's a merciful God. God showed mercy to you and your family. He said he will be merciful unto those he wants to be merciful unto, and he will be gracious unto those that he wants to be gracious unto. So I want to open your mouth and tell him, oh Lord, I thank you because you are good. I give you glory for your goodness. Lord, I appreciate you. You are a merciful God. Your mercy endureth forever. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. The will of God is for us to show gratitude. That's in 1 Thessalonians chapter 5 verse 18, sir. If you can just show it for me. 1 Thessalonians 5 verse 18. It makes us to know that God's will for us is for us to thank him. God's will for us is for us to show gratitude, to appreciate him. He said, in everything, give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. Did you see that? He said what? In everything. So it doesn't matter what the situation is. It doesn't matter what the challenges are. It doesn't matter what your shortcomings are. Child of God, tonight I want you to open your mouth and appreciate God, because God is going to do something new. God is about to do something new in your life tonight. So I want you to open your mouth and begin to appreciate him. Open your mouth and say something to him. Say, Father, I thank you for tonight. I thank you for making it possible that I'm part of this meeting tonight. I'm thanking you for what you're about to do. You need to use this meeting to bless me tonight. I want you to appreciate God. The Bible said the will of God is for us to thank him. So I want you to open your mouth and say, thank you, Jesus. I want you to open your mouth and say, thank you, Jesus, for this is your will. I'm thanking you. I'm appreciating you. I am not complaining. I'm not crying. I'm not in a mood. I'm not moody. But this hour, I'm grateful. It would have been worse if not for you. In the name of Jesus, I'm thanking you. My brother, my sister, in Acts chapter 16, Paul and Silas was whipped and thrown into jail. And they were, instead of crying, instead of lamenting, but they were thanking God, believing God that there will be a turnaround. And there was a turnaround. So I don't know what is bringing your morale down. I don't know what you are going through. I don't care what you are going through. But I know there's a God that can turn things around. I know there's a God that can overturn for you. So I want you to appreciate him. I want you to get into an attitude of appreciation. Appreciate God, for it's the will of God for you to thank him. It's the will of God for you to thank him, not to ask questions. I want you to appreciate God tonight, because God is going to do great things in your life. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. We want to ask God for forgiveness. The Bible in 1 John chapter 1, 19. If you can put it, that's fine. He said, if we confess our sin, and he will forgive us. So it's time that he wants you to confess. Don't allow sin hinder your blessings tonight. The only thing that separates God from man is sin. Inasmuch as you are in sin, then God has left you already. God left you already. So I want you to say, Father, forgive me wherever I offended you. I want you to open your mouth and begin to pray. I want you to pray your own way. You can pray your own language. Ask God for forgiveness. Ask God for mercy. That scripture says, if we confess our sin, He is faithful and just to forgive us our sin and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. It's a time that I'm asking Him to ask for forgiveness. Ask for mercy. Ask for mercy. The Lord prayer says, forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those that trespasses against us. As you are asking God for mercy, I also want you to release whoever you have in your heart. Whoever that offended you, that you are still holding in your heart, I want you to release the person. Forgive the person. Ask God that God will help you, that you forgive the person in the name of Jesus. Remember, He said, come on, He said, forgive. You know, so that you'll be forgiven also. You know, if you don't forgive the person that offends you, God in heaven will not forgive you. So it's time to let it go. It's time to release yourself. It's time to free yourself in the name of Jesus. Free yourself from whoever that offended you, from whoever that you are holding, whoever that is against you, that you are holding, that offended you. I want you to pray and forgive that person so that your heavenly Father will forgive you in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. The theme for the weekend is what? Thou shall prosper. Oh, you don't even know the theme. You know the theme? Okay, I want you to talk to me as you know it. What's the theme for the weekend? Tell your neighbor, God will prosper you in the mighty name of Jesus. So let's go to Philippians chapter 4 verse 19. Philippians chapter 4 verse 19 is where the next prayer point is. 4:19 is where the next prayer point is. If you have a Bible with you, you can turn to Philippians chapter 4 verse 19. Today will be a great night. I am well positioned. I'm ready to be blessed. I want to believe that you are ready to be blessed also. Hallelujah, somebody. If you look at my right hand side, you see the quality of musicians in the house. I know all of them are ready to download. Somebody shout hallelujah. I'm not going to take your time too long because I want to also listen to the administration. But let's just pray and declare the service open. I want you to turn your Bible to Philippians 4:19. Philippians 4:19. Are we there? Are we there? Let's read together. 1, 2, go. But my God shall supply according to His riches in glory by Christ Jesus. Say, but my God. He didn't say you. He didn't say I am the architect. He says God is the supplier. So the prayer point is, God, supply all my needs. God, I need divine provision. Let there be divine provision for me this year in the name of Jesus. Your word said you will supply all my needs according to His riches, according to your riches in glory by Christ Jesus. So let's just open your mouth and ask God. Let God be there for you. Let God be God in your life. Let your needs be met. Let God supply your needs. Let your needs be met in the name of Jesus. I don't know what you are believing God for, but God is a God that answers prayers. And God is a God that knows your needs. He's the one that will supply it. He's the one that will make it available in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. I want you to hold somebody. We are still praying. I want you to hold somebody. One person. 1-1-2-2-2-2-2. Just hold somebody. Now you pray that prayer, you will be praying, interceding for that person. Write the person, you know, the person will be praying for you. You will ask God to supply the needs of that person, the needs of your brother, the needs of your sister, according to His riches. That God should make a way where there seems to be no way. When all doors are closed, let the door be open. In the name, begin to pray. You are interceding for somebody. Open your mouth and intercede for somebody. That God will supply his needs. That God will let his needs be met according to his riches. According to his riches in glory. In the name of in the mighty name of Jesus, that God will supply his needs, that God will supply his needs in the name of Jesus, according to his riches, according to his riches in glory. God has a plan. God has a plan for your brother or sister. Ask God that, let God fulfill his plan concerning your sister. Let God honor his word in the life of your sister or in the life of your brother. Pray for somebody. Intercede for somebody. Ask God to answer somebody speedily. He said, my God shall supply. My God shall supply. God is a divine supplier. God is the one that supplies. It's not by your power. It's not by your ability. After all, he says, by your strength shall no man prevail. Tonight, you're asking God, let somebody's needs be met in the name of Jesus. Let somebody's needs be met in the name of Jesus. God will supply the needs of somebody. God will supply the needs of your sister in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. In Jesus' name, we pray. The next prayer point is Psalm 128. We want to read verse 2. And I want you to locate your next prayer partner. You are done with your neighbor. Maybe that neighbor was praying like a barrister. Now I want to locate a neighbor that will pray like a prayer warrior. A neighbor that will intercede like that, like he wants a speedy answer. I want you to please put on the screen for us Psalm 128. Psalm 128 verse 2 is the next prayer point. But before we start praying, I want us to read from the screen. If you are there, let's just turn your eyes. Let's read together. He said, for thou shall eat the labor of thy hands. Happy shall thou be, and it shall be well with you. I want us to read it again with understanding, so that when we start praying, you know what you are praying. Let's read it together again. 1, 2, go. Shall eat the labor of thy hands. Happy shall thou be, and it shall be well with you. Tell your neighbor, it shall be well with you. Tell your neighbor, it shall be well with you. Say, neighbor, you will eat the labor of your hands in the mighty name of. So that's the prayer point. I want you to pray for somebody that the labor of his hands, the person will eat it. You cannot labor without result. You cannot labor, and you labor, and all your labor goes in vain. I want you to pray for somebody tonight. In the name of Jesus. You will eat the labor. You will eat the labor of your hands. The labor of your hands, you shall hear it. You shall eat it in the name of Jesus. Whatever you sow, you know, it will prosper. It will grow. It will form fruitful. It will bear fruits in the name of Jesus. The labor will not go in vain in the mighty name of Jesus. Your labor will not go in vain. Your efforts will not go in vain in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. I want to hear believing amen. Zechariah chapter 4 verse 8 to 9 is the next prayer point. Look for a prayer warrior. Look for a prayer warrior. We are interceding for one another. I have only 1-2 minutes. I'm done. Look for the next person. Look for the next person. While you are preparing, Zechariah chapter 4 verse 8 to 9. Chapter 4 verse 8 to 9. Hallelujah. The theme of the conference is thou shall prosper. Tell your neighbor, neighbor. Say, neighbor. You will prosper. Say, neighbor, you will prosper in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Zechariah chapter 4, we want to read verse 8 to 9. Then I'm going to show you what the prayer point looks like. Verse 8 says, moreover, the word of the Lord came unto me, saying, number 9, the hands of Zerubbabel have laid the foundation of this house. His hands shall also finish it. And thou shalt know that the Lord of hosts had sent me unto you. You want to pray for somebody that God will perfect everything that concerns him in the name of Jesus. God will perfect everything that you've started. You will complete it. You will finish it. Our God will perfect your business. Our God will perfect your financial life. In the name of Jesus, there will be a turnaround in your financial life after this meeting. Everything that concerns you, everything that concerns your family, everything that concerns you, God will perfect it. Liba santerere rebo sanderere, laba santerere lekebo sanderere. In the name of Jehovah God, our God will prosper you. Our God will prosper you. Our God will prosper you. In the name of Jesus, everything that concerns you, God will perfect it. The scripture says, the hands of Zerubbabel have laid a foundation, and his hands are also finishing. And thou shalt know that God is involved. So I want you to pray for somebody. Ask God to complete it. That which your sister, that which your brother started, that God will perfect it. That they will complete it. They will reap the fruits of their labor. Prosperity is going to be their portion. In the name of Jesus, they will not fail. They will not fail. Failure will be far from them. After this weekend, after this weekend, after this weekend, there will be divine turnaround in their businesses. After this weekend, there will be divine turnaround in their financial life. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. I want to hear believing amen. Amen. The last prayer point is Genesis chapter 1 verse 28. Genesis chapter 1 verse 28 is the last for tonight. Tonight we came to learn how to make money. So we've just praying to clear way so that when the man of God take over, then we start learning. But just the last prayer point. Genesis chapter 1 verse 28. And that is the last person you'll be praying for now. Maybe later on we might pray again, maybe. But for now, please, sir, can you show it? Genesis chapter 1, verse 28. Or if you have your Bible, you can turn with me. Okay. If you are there, shout hallelujah. Can we read together? I want to go. And God, are we there? Okay, let's read together from the Bible. Want to go. And God blessed them. And God said unto them, be fruitful and multiply and replenish the earth and subdue it and have dominion over the fish of the sea and over the fowl of the air and over every living thing that moveth upon the earth. Hallelujah. The last person you are praying for, you pray that that person will not be barren. That the business will not be barren. That fruitfulness will come into that business. Even the business that will start after this weekend, that fruitfulness will be the portion of that business. Is it a good prayer point? Do you have a praying partner? Do you have a praying partner? I want you to begin to pray now. Ask God for fruitfulness. Ask God for fruitfulness in someone's life, in someone's finances, in someone's business. In the name of Jesus, that someone's business will be fruitful. In the name of promotion is around the corner, that somebody will be promoted. In the someone will be elevated. In the name of Jesus, because of this weekend, somebody will put a business together and the business will be fruitful. In the name of Jesus, let fruitfulness come into the life of the person. Let God make the person be fruitful. Ask for fruitfulness. In the name of Jesus, ask for fruitfulness. Ask for fruitfulness. Ask for fruitfulness. Ask for fruitfulness in the life of the person you're holding, in the ministry of that person. Your ministry will be fruitful in the name of Jesus. Your family, there will be fruitfulness in the name of Jesus. Whatever your hand touches, barrenness will be far from you. You will prosper. Your family will prosper. Your business will prosper in the name of Jesus. Your business will prosper. Your family will prosper in the name of Jesus. You will not be barren. Thou shall not be barren. Your business shall not be barren in the name of Jesus. Your business will not be barren in the name. You will not be barren in the name of Jesus. You will not be barren. You will be fruitful. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. In Jesus' name, we pray. Tell your neighbor, fruitfulness is your portion. Say, you will not be barren. Say, you will not be barren. Say, you will be fruitful in the mighty name of Jesus. And I declare the service open in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Spirit. And the people of God shall say, amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's continue in that attitude to give him praise, to worship his holy name. Father Lord, you are worthy to be praised. We give you praise. We exalt your holy name. We thank you for tonight. We thank you for the things you're doing. We thank you for what you're going to do. We appreciate you. Just lift up Hallelujah. Your hands. Give him praise.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Just give him all the worship.
Hallelujah.
Oh, Lord, we give you praise. Hallelujah. Glory, 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 glory to your name.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. As we gather, may your spirit dwell within us. As we gather, may we glorify your name. Knowing well that hearts begin to worship. We'll be blessed. We'll be blessed because we came. Oh, we'll be blessed. We'll be blessed because we came.
To this house. Oh Lord, let your praises fill our lives. Oh, let it fill our minds tonight. Tonight, let it back to the offer. Let it offer on to you, Jesus. A praise, a glory, a worship tonight. Worship him. Him alone deserves all the glory. Him alone deserves all the praise. Jesus, you alone. You alone deserve all the worship tonight. Take all the glory. Take all the honor. Oh, we worship you tonight. Nobody like you, Jesus. You deserve the glory and the honor and the power and praise. Jesus, you alone. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. I can hear it tonight. We're going to do that again. Somebody shout, hallelujah. Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We are perfect in you. I praise your name. I praise your name. Oh, I praise your name. We are complete. Say we are
complete.
Tonight we are
in you.
I praise your name. I praise your name. Oh yes, I praise your name. We are perfect.
We are perfect
in you. Oh, I praise your name. I praise your name. Oh yes, I praise your name. We are complete.
We are complete
in Jesus.
In you,
I praise your name. I praise your name. Oh yes, I praise your name. For upon me, for upon me is your glory and your
grace.
And upon me,
and upon me is your beauty and your love.
Upon me,
for upon me
is your glory and your
grace.
Oh, and upon me,
and upon
it's your beauty and your love
from the grave.
your name.
Oh, thank you, Lord.
Praise your name.
We have hungry.
We have hungry
in you.
In you.
I praise your name.
Praise your name.
Oh, thank you, Lord.
I praise your name.
We are perfect.
We are perfect.
In Jesus.
In you.
I praise your name.
Oh yes,
Lord, I
praise your name.
And we are complete.
We are complete
in you.
In you.
I praise your name.
Praise your name.
Everybody praise your name tonight.
I praise your name.
We are perfect.
We are perfect
in Jesus.
In you.
I praise your name.
Oh yes,
Lord, I
praise your name.
I believe,
rock for me.
Take is the glory
at your name.
Oh, and I want me.
And I want me.
Oh Lord, it's your beauty
at your love.
Rock for me.
Rock for me.
Take is the glory
at your name.
And I want me.
Yes, Lord, 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 yes, Lord,
praise, O Lord, tonight. We give you glory. We give you all the glory, Lord. Take all the glory. All the glory and all the honor belongs to you, O God. It belongs to you, Jehovah. It belongs to you, Jehovah. Take all our praise, all our shouting, all our worshiping tonight. It belongs to you. It belongs to you, Jesus. Oh, thank you, Lord. It belongs to you. All the glory belongs to you, Jesus. We worship you, Jesus. Just worship you. Thank you, Jehovah. Thank you, Jehovah. We give you praise tonight. Hallelujah to your name. We give you glory, Lord, as we honor you. We give you glory, Lord, as we honor you. You are wonderful. You are worthy, oh Lord. You are wonderful.
worship you tonight, oh God. We give you praise. We exalt your holy name, oh God. You are worthy to be praised. You are worthy to be praised. Yes, Lord, the unlimited God, unstoppable God, greater than the greatest God, mighty God. We give you praise, ancient of days. We worship you. Thank you, Jehovah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah to your name, Lord. You are worthy. Thank you, Jehovah. In Jesus' name.
Amen. Hallelujah. Let's just begin to worship him, the King of Kings. Arugu Ojo, the Ancient of Days. Worship him. Please don't low down. Keep praising. Keep praising. He is the King of Kings. He's the chairman of this meeting tonight. He is the I am that I am, the great God, the all-sufficient God, the one who is once and forevermore. Please don't low down that worship. Don't low down that worship. Oh, Prince of Peace. Meze pralomo shakata yaga. Libra labo sikete yege liba mama mama kayeke yege la bababa. Mazumbre lebo sikrebo sikrebo sikrebo. Leba mama mama. The one that is was forevermore. The one that holds the heavens and make the head his footstool. The great God. The Prince of Peace. The Lion of the tribe of Judah. The fourth man in the fire. The God of Abraham. The God of Isaac. The God of Jacob. Oh, Jehovah Jireh. Jehovah Sikenu. Jehovah Rapha. Jehovah Heleon. The everlasting God. We worship you, the Ancient of Days. How old are you, O God? You are bigger than the biggest, higher than the highest. Oh, sweet God, we bless your name. You are beautiful. You are bigger than what people say. Jehovah, bigger than what people say. You are bigger than what people say. Jehovah,
bigger than what people say.
Oh, Jehovah, you are good. You are kind. You are bigger than
what people say.
Hey, Jehovah, you are my Lord, you are kind. You are bigger than what people say. Eleon, you are my God, you are kind.
You are bigger than what people say.
Prince of Peace, you are good. You are kind. You are bigger than what people say. Amen. Hallelujah. Lord, we worship you tonight. Prince of Peace, we give you all the glory. We magnify your holy name. We declare your lordship in the meeting tonight, O God. We say more of you tonight. None of us, O God. Father, Lord, we step aside for you, O God, to step in tonight in the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you. We give you all the praise because you are going to perform wonders in our midst tonight. We thank you for your presence in our midst, Lord. We praise you because you are not a man. You are not a man. You are not a man. You are God, the living God that can do all things. The God of perfection. Oh, we worship you. The great I am. Blessed be your name. For in Jesus' name we have worship. Amen. Hallelujah. Let's give a shout to the Lord. Hallelujah. Even though you will not go back home the same, shout hallelujah. If you know that the Lord will restore you tonight, shout hallelujah. If you know that the Lord will bless your hand and make you prosper tonight, shout hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's have our seat. Amen. Sit with joy tonight. Amen. Be excited tonight. I know everyone is expectant tonight. Amen. Hallelujah. My assignment here is to pray for our family. And I know everyone here is represented as the family. Amen. I want to just give a short, words about, the family. And this is how, our pastor has been teaching us about family, about our marriage, how our family can grow in the Lord. Hallelujah. But I want us to know something, that the founder of family is God. And without God, family cannot stand. You know that? Because God is number one. And that is why he started with Adam and Eve. God is interested in family. God loves family. And that is why he created Adam and Eve. And he did not stop there. He made us to know that family have to start from there. And he declared a word upon them. He said, be fruitful and multiply. And this is our team. The team is thou shalt prosper. And without fruitfulness, that is no prosperity. Amen. And God is a God of prosperity. And I see that in the book of Genesis. How did he do that? God created everything in the garden. He created trees, he created rivers that will flow to make the garden beautiful, to make the garden grow. And what happened? God gave man wisdom. He gives man knowledge that out of these trees, out of all the things he has created, he can make it prosper, fruitful. That is why today you have a chair to sit down. It is the wisdom, the knowledge that God gave man to say that this tree can produce tree. I mean, can produce a chair. It can make out tree. I mean, chair from this tree. It can also make the rubber coming out from this tree to do something, you know, different things. Amen. And that is why we are prospering today. Amen. Hallelujah. So I want us to know something, that God loves us. The desire for God for a family is for family to be healthy, for family to be strong. And I know that that is our desire too. Our desire is for our family to be strong, to be healthy, our family to be good, to prosper, you know, our family to be united, you know, to be in love, to be in peace. And that is the design of God for us. Amen. But something is wrong somewhere that is happening, and that is the reality that we see in the family. Amen. The reality that we see in the family that is going on up today is unhappiness. We see neglection. We see abandon. We see, you know, hatred, not being loved in the family. And the result of this is a problem. And that is what some family are going through today. And that is why we need to pray for our family. We need to persist in praying for our family so that devil will not use this to destroy homes. And that is why we see separation today. When father and mother are not loving one another, and when children, you know, not being loved, and that is what is going on. There's misunderstanding in the family. And children will see that my father is not loving me, my father doesn't understand. Like the children of Nigeria, they said, oh, these Nigerian parents, they don't understand. But you know one thing that Paul, apostle, told us in the book of Colossians chapter 3 verses 18 to 21. It says, wives, submit yourself to your husband. It's telling the Colossians family so that the family can be strong and healthy. And the only thing that the family need is Christ. Christ. When Jesus is absent in your family, it cannot stand. A family that is not holding well can never stand. And a family that is divided cannot stand. And that is why the Bible says in the book of Exodus that enchantment, that is no, there shall be no enchantment against your family or deviation against your family. Amen. Somebody say amen. If you believe, say amen. Hallelujah. Amen. So I want us to know that the original design that God has for you as a family, father, mother, and children, is that there should be love. There should be time for one another. There should be commitments. Amen? There should be understanding. The Bible says also that same Colossians, it said, husband, love your wife. Please, I want us to open to that before we start praying, because we are going to use those prayer verses to pray tonight. Amen. Colossians chapter 3, verses 18. This is what we hear every day from our pastors, even from the program that they are teaching us about marriage. Amen. Hallelujah. Colossians chapter 3. We start from 18. I want us to know that this is continual. It's present tense that Paul, Apostle Paul, is telling us here. Hallelujah. It says that,
sorry. Yeah. He says, wives, submit to your husband as is fitting. Fitting, that is continuous. Continuous. I know some wives find it difficult to be submissive to their husband. You don't submit when you need something from your husband. You don't submit when you need to get something or you want your husband to do you something good. Whether it is good or bad, you have to be submissive. Amen. And the other verse says that husband, love your wives as never treat them harshly. This is present tense. It's telling you continuously. I know sometimes husband find it too hard to love. No matter if they find it too hard, they find it difficult. But whether it is bad time or good time, just love. And when these are absent in the family, I am telling you, it can never stand. That is the opportunity that devil comes in to divide the family, to separate homes. I'm telling you this so that we can know how to pray, to attack. I don't know how your family is right now. I don't know what you are going through. I don't know the challenges you are going through right now. But I'm trying to break this down for you so that you know, is it because I'm not loving my wife enough? That is why my marriage is disordered. Is it not that I'm not submissive to my husband enough? That is why things is not going well. Is it because I'm too harsh on my children? That is why my children are disobeying or they are being discouraged about me or we parents. Hallelujah. So I want us to rise on our feet tonight and begin to appreciate God for what he has done, even to make you a family, even to make you to be a family. Just thank God for his goodness. Thank God for your family tonight. Thank God for your husband. Thank God for your wife. Thank God for your children. Because God is so faithful, the desire for God for your life is for your marriage to be sweet, for your family to be wonderful, to be healthy, to be strong. Appreciate God and say, Father, I thank you for this opportunity because I know this is my night of deliverance. This is my night for my family to be rebuilt, to be restored. This is the night, oh God, that my family will prosper in the name of Jesus. Ye kalabo santa la baba shekrebo. Father, Lord, we thank you. We bless your holy name. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Amen. I'm saying that the house that is divided cannot stand. And I'm saying in the book of Numbers 23, verse 23, it says that there shall no enchantment against Jacob. That is against Olowa, my family. So you put your family there. No deviation against Olowa. That is what you would decree. That there shall be no enchantment, no deviation in my family. We open your mouth and use it as a prayer point that in the name of Jesus, I decree, according to the word of God in Numbers 23, there shall be no deviation in my family, in my marriage, in the name of Jesus. Devil will have no chance. Devil will have no way in my family, in the name of Jesus. I cancel the spirit of deviation, in the name of Jesus. I cancel, in the name of Jesus. It shall not stand. In my home, it shall not stand. In my family, in the name of Jesus, it shall not stand. You spirit of divination, in the name of Jesus, I cast you out of my home. I cast you out of my family, in the name of Jesus. Oh, Mazika Tori Barabashanta Yaga. Lord Jesus, we thank you. Blessed be your name. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Amen. You know, when family lives together, they encounter all types of problems. They encounter all types of troubles. Amen. We are going to pray in the name of Jesus that whatever problem that is going on in my family, in my marriage, that has become a battle that I'm going through now, oh Lord, remove it. In the name of Jesus, open your mouth. I don't know. You know that type of things. When family come together, you know the type of things that happens in the home. You know the type of things that happen. What is happening in your family now? Ask God, what is that thing, oh God? What is that thing that has become a battle in my family? Is it barrenness? It is financial disorder? Lord Jehovah, remove it in the name of Jesus. Whatever problem that has become a battle in my family, that have become a battle in my home, is it concerning your children? Lord Jesus, I pray, oh God, Lord, remove it, Lord. Remove it, remove it. Are you praying? Let heaven hear your voice this morning. If you don't want to go back the same, open your mouth and pray that, Lord, what is that problem? What is that type of problem that has become a battle? That has become a battle in my life. Lord Jesus, settle it tonight. Father, settle that problem tonight. In my home, in my family, Lord, settle it, oh God. In my marriage, in the name of Jesus. Oh, masakra basu krebo shata. Libra la baba, maze krebobo. Open your mouth and begin to pray. Every satanic instrument that is fighting my home, a spirit of lack, in the name of Jesus, I rebuke you. I cast you out of my home in the name of Jesus. Spirit of division, I cast you out in the name of Jesus. Spirit of abuse, I cast you out. Sexual assault, I cast you out. Verbal abuse, I cast you out. Selfishness, I cast you out. Hatred, I cast you out. Unforgiveness, I cast you out. Disunity, I cast you out. Misunderstanding, I cast you out. Unfaithfulness, I cast you out. In the name of Jesus, you that power, mazokra bakaye krebo, that want to separate my home, that want to separate my family, in the name of Jesus, I bind you. In the name of Jesus, I bind you. In the name of Jesus, ye krababa, spirit of infirmity, I cast you out. Spirit of disagreement, in the name of Jesus, enough is enough. I cast you out of my home. I cast you out of my family. In the name of Jesus, mazopraka ye krebo sata. Ye galababa mazumbrelebo sata. Ye krebo sata. Father, Lord, we thank you. In Jesus' name we have prayed. We are going to pray. Oh Lord, grant us special wisdom to train our children in your glory. That Lord should give us special wisdom. Because we need a special wisdom to train these children. You know, these children of this nowadays, this generation that we have, they will tell you that, Mom, that is not the way. But they don't know that the parents have passed through that stage. But they will tell you what they are now. But we need wisdom. Because we don't have wisdom to bring up these children, to tell them that this is not the way. They will think that you are telling them the wrong thing. From there, they will begin to leave the home. Because they get another information out there. And I pray that the devil will not separate our children from us in Jesus' name. So I want us to open our mouth and say, Father, grant me wisdom. Grant me special wisdom to train my children in your glory. Oh Lord, I pray as a parent, as a mother, as a father, Lord, I need special wisdom to train my children, oh God, in your glory. I don't want them, oh God, to mingle with the civilization of this world. I don't want them, oh God, Lord, oh God, to be lost with the civilization of this world. Lord Jesus, Lord, help me. Oh Lord, release upon me special wisdom, oh God, to bring these children up in your way, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Mazopralababa, in Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. Father, Lord, we just thank you. But finally, I want us to pray, which I don't want to miss that. Amen. The most important thing is that we have a father and a mother in this house. Amen. And we are the children. We are the people that God has placed in his hands. If we are not prospering, they will not be happy. But I want you to also know something, that they are not perfect. They need our prayers. They are also a woman being like us. Forget about the title. I want us to pray for them, that the Lord God Almighty will uphold them, that they will not fall, they will not be tired, they will not be weak. That more grace, more anointing, more unction in the name of, just open your mouth to pray. Pray for the father and the mother in this house. As you pray for them, God will raise men to pray for you in the name of Jesus. Father, Lord, we just thank you, oh God, for papa and mama in this house, Lord. Lord, the one that you have ordained, oh God. Lord, we pray that you will give them strength, fresh unction, fresh anointing on daily basis. Lord, we pray they will not be weak, they will not be weary, they will not be tired, oh God. Lord, you will lift them up. Lord, you will prosper them on every side in the name of Jesus. Lord, you, oh God, you will honor them with the ornament of grace in the name of Jesus. Lord, we pray, oh God, that you will make them great. You will establish them strongly, Lord, in the name of Jesus. You will speak their feet, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus, Lord. Father, Lord, we pray that no enchantment against their house, their home, in the name of Jesus. No divination against their family, in the name of Jesus. Every plan of the enemy against them, we destroy in the name of Jesus. They will rise, they will shine, in the name of Jesus. The Lord, we expand their ministry, in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, we just thank you, we bless your holy name. We give you all the glory. Hallelujah. Lord, we worship. Just begin to appreciate God. Begin to thank God for what God has done tonight. Appreciate him and say, Lord, you are wonderful. Blessed be your name, O God. For in Jesus' name we have prayed. Let somebody shout hallelujah. If you know you are blessed by this prayer, shout hallelujah. Amen.
Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. Amen. Can we have our seat, please? It's testimony time. It is time to testify of the goodness of the Lord. What no man can do, he has done for me. Oh Lord, you are worthy to be praised. What no man can do, he has done for me. Oh Lord, you are worthy to be praised.
Hallelujah. Praise. Amen. I didn't mean to sing this song. I just want to use it to awaken us. Amen. It's testimony time. If you know the Lord has done something wonderful, something great. I'm sure every one of us seated here, we are all, you know, testimonies. For the Lord has done so much more for us. And God is faithful. The Bible says, for they overcame or overcame by the blood of the Lamb, right? And by the words of their testimonies. So how many overcomers do we have in the house? Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. Do we have anyone here testifying? Okay, we have one person, two, three, four. Okay, please, can you just come out and just file up here? Sister Justina, number one. Sister Jumoke, two. And my sister, three. Brother Adiola, number four. Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. I just want to thank God for Johnny Mercies. God is faithful. I traveled to Nigeria and I saw all my kids, my grandkids, and everybody's doing well, and my siblings. I just thank God for his faithfulness. And I just want us to continue to, I know every time people come from Nigeria, we talk about praying for Nigeria. I'm not going to say we should pray for Nigeria. God is already doing his thing. I just want us to remember that we have a lot of assignment in Nigeria. It wasn't by mistake. We recognize God indeed will be. Other people, other religion will see what God is using us to do. So I just want to thank God for his faithfulness. I was sick while I was there and I just didn't know I was going to make it. But, you know, God kept me through. God used so many people to bless me, Pastor Yemi and Pastor Comfort. I mean, thank you. I want to thank you guys. And I want to thank my children for really supporting me during the trip. And also for a lot of great things that people, there are so many great, wonderful people that God has really placed on earth. And we are all amongst those people. So may God continue to use each and every one of us to be a light, because this world has a lot of darkness. And it is very apparent when you go to Nigeria. May God continue to use us to be the light. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. Thank God for that testimonies. Thank God for Johnny Mercies. Thank God for his healing power upon your life. Amen.
Praise the Lord. My testimony is a work in progress. Last week, Tuesday, I believe, I applied for a job at my current position, my current workplace. And the next day, I got a phone interview. And the phone interview went well. and I thought I actually had the position. And Monday, I got an email saying I'd been rejected for the position. I wasn't really sure why, because I know I qualified for it. But on Wednesday, 2 days ago, I got a call as well as an email saying, oh, the email I got was an error generated by the computer, that I actually qualified for the position, so I should come in for an interview today. I went for the interview, went pretty well, and I know that God who started the work shall bring its completion. Amen.
Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. You've just said it, that God who started his work will perfect it in Jesus' name. And I pray that no one will take your place in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen.
I want to thank God for Johnny Mercy's and for answered prayers. We went to Baltimore for my mother-in-law's funeral. But 2 weeks before the funeral, God asked us to raise a prayer point about the weather. We were not sure what was going on with the weather. And so we raised that prayer point and we kept praying. Monday, snowstorm. And I remember my sister-in-law calling me, saying, Stajbake, will you be able to make it? I said, I will leave California and I will arrive there on Tuesday at the same time and nothing will change. Baltimore was cold as, I can't even, it was minus. And we kept praying. We fasted that week and started praying. I remember one of them saying, are we going to wear socks inside Buba? And we said, we won't wear socks inside Buba. But, you know, Wednesday got cold. Thursday got cold. Friday, we did not use the jackets for the service of song. And then on Saturday, the funeral itself, we did not even use a jacket. And I want to thank God. And Monday, when everybody went back, the cold went back to Baltimore. So I want to praise God. You know, we may think it's a small thing, though, but 2 weeks before, God gave us that prayer point to raise. And I want to thank God that none of us got stuck at the airport. None of us missed the flight. Everybody that came from Nigeria, Brazil, London, everybody came safely and went back safely. So I want to give God the glory.
Amen. God is faithful. He's a prayer answering God. And we also want to thank God for Johnny Mercy's for her too, in Jesus' name.
Praise the Lord. I want to thank God for Johnny Mercy's. I put in an application about 2 weeks ago and it was denied. They're about to turn to something else. But God in his infinite mercy turned everything around. I've been to Canada like 3 times in the last 2 weeks. But God eventually yesterday just changed it. And I want to give him all the glory. I also want to thank my wonderful wife. She's beyond what anyone can think of.
Hallelujah. He's a faithful God. Amen. Thank God for that testimony. It's wonderful.
Praise God. I don't remember giving testimony. I think I did one time when I had my son about 7-8 years ago. So I wanted to give this testimony because I traveled out of the country earlier this year, and 2 days before my trip, I lost my wallet. And I had a whole lot of things in the wallet, and I was supposed to actually travel to LA. I was going to pick up a rental car because I wanted to drive to LA. So I lost my wallet and I can't travel. And my trip, the clients have booked my flight and I was supposed to get on the plane coming back from LA. So I was really mad, I was upset. So I made a declaration that I'm gonna find my wallet. So I just drove out, I took the BART train. So it got lost. So I went to the police station, they said, oh, the wallet is gone. If you found it, they would have called me. So I got on the car and I was driving around. I said, I'm looking for my wallet. So I got back home. And later that night, I just got a knock at my door. I keep telling my wife, I'm going to find this wallet. I'm going to travel. So I got a knock at my door, and it was a police officer. And he said that, is this where Benjamin Adeyanju lives? I said, yes, because my old address was in my ID. So there was no way they could trace it. So I asked him, how did you guys find me? He said, oh, somebody saw an expired new driver's insurance card and they track it to the house. So I got my wallet. Now, the reason why I'm giving this testimony is now I lost my passport and I have to travel again. So I was praying about that. And the Lord said, well, why don't you testify to the wallet that you found? Maybe the Lord will give you your passport. So I said, but I don't give testimony publicly, and I'm due to travel soon. So Lord, I just thank you for my wallet. And you know, so I can find my passport. Praise God.
Hallelujah. You will find your passport in Jesus' name. Amen. Can we rise up on our feet? Let's just thank God for those testimonies. Let's give him thanks. Let's give God praise. Let's worship him. Let's thank him. Let's thank him for the lives of those that traveled and they came back safely. Let's thank God for those that were sick and God healed them. Let's just give him praise. Let's give him glory. Let's just thank God for the opportunity he has given us to testify of his goodness. It could only be God. He's a faithful God. It's only him. It's all about him. Just worship him. Just thank him. Give him thanks for divine health. Thank him for life, for good health. Thank him for peace. Thank him for joy. Thank him for everything. Just thank him because your testimony is about to start again tonight in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank him because you know we are not living here the same way we came in. Lord, we thank you, Father. We bless your holy name. We worship you, Lord. Blessed be your holy name forever. We cover those testimonies with the blood of Jesus. We thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we have prayed.
Hallelujah. Put your hands together for the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. You may be seated. We welcome all of us to this seminar tonight. This is the first time we're doing our program at this hour because it's special. And I know that all of you that are here, you're special. And I believe that you will never go the same. Something will be added to you. Anytime you appear in Zion, it's a time to be added to. Anytime you come to Zion, is a time to be added to. So I don't want you to see it as a waste of time. Because surely I know something shall be added unto you. That is not a believing amen. Tonight, tomorrow, and Sunday, I know my financial life will never remain the same. Amen. Amen. I want to welcome all of us, especially, you know, I felt so small around when I was sitting in front here this night. Because around me, I just saw a lot of GOs, general overseers. And I'm just like a parish pastor. So I welcome all the general, but all the people who are, you know, in the front tonight, you know, apart from myself and my wife, they are general overseers. They are president founders. I'm just a parish pastor, man. Praise the Lord. I welcome Pastor Yemi Isaac all the way from Lagos. Let's put our hands together for Pastor Yemi Isaac. His bio is a general overseer of Christ Love Rema Chapel International in Ikorodu, Lagos. You know, it's a pleasure having you around. The Lord bless you, sir. I would know that, you know, this time that you are with us, you know, you will be blessed and we'll be blessed together in Jesus' name. Now, I have another general overseer by his side, you know, Pastor Okomo. He's the president founder. Victory Palace in Pittsburgh. You are welcome, sir. The Lord bless you. Praise the Lord. I have another general overseer, you know, president founder. His own, I will leave his own till. Praise the Lord. But tonight, the Lord wants to bless us and the Lord wants to minister to us. We started last Sunday by, you know, bringing somebody to talk to us about our children education.
People think church is only spiritual. Church is only to come and pray, to fast. Church is all encompassing. I wish above all things that thou mayest prosper and be in health, even as your soul prospereth. So spirit, soul, and body, we must prosper. So when we put things together like this, people think, oh, you know, we suppose it's only, you know, you need knowledge. You know, for my people perish for lack of knowledge. So when knowledge is there, there is illumination. Whenever there is knowledge, there is illumination. There is brightness. You know, knowledge is power. Amen. So tonight, we have somebody in the house that's going to be talking to us briefly, you know, about 15, 20 minutes before, you know, our guest speaker will come. And tomorrow they will continue. So I want you to get your papers and your pens, you know, you're writing something. Get something. Praise the Lord. We don't know all things, so get something. You see, somebody who is wise, you will make the wisdom of somebody. You pick a little here, a little there, a little here, and before you know, you are becoming a master yourself. Praise the Lord. So tonight, the first person that will be talking to us, you know, is a client executive with Trans America Retirement Solutions. She manages retirement plans for large corporations, and she has worked in that capacity for 16 years. Praise the Lord. She's a mother of three beautiful children. She's a wife married to a man. Praise the Lord. And the husband is a man. Do you know we have two women? They say one is husband, one is... But this one, the husband is a man. The woman husband. Praise the Lord. Her husband just testified now and said, point to... You know, his wife. I want us to welcome Sister Funmi Alade as she ministered to present something to us tonight. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Thank you so much. God bless you, sir. I really am so thankful for the privilege of speaking before you great people tonight. I thank you, Pastor Yemi and Pastor Comfort. You guys have been awesome to our family, and you know, it's always good to know that you are in the right place and that you have pastors after the heart of God who are always encouraging you, building you up with the word of God and celebrating all your victories. And I thank you, Sa and Ma. And I know that God will continue to increase you in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Now, I pray that God is going to help me figure out how to make this thing work. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Just a short word of prayer. Father, I thank you for the opportunity to minister you to your people tonight. Holy Spirit, I ask that you take charge in the name of Jesus, that you speak through me. And that you let your people be built up tonight in the name of Jesus. Let them learn something new, something practical, something applicable that can transform their financial life and indeed cause them to prosper in the name of Jesus. Amen. Praise the Lord. Okay, so my responsibility tonight is to talk about budgeting. Hallelujah. Amen. I know a lot of us don't like that word. I actually love the word budgeting, and I love it so much that sometimes if I'm having a tough day, I just go through my budget and balance it, and I just feel good. Hallelujah. Sister Justina is smiling because she really knows that that is the truth. You know, it's something wonderful that we just need to embrace. Hallelujah. It is one of the ways that God, you know, helps us to manage our resources. You know, it's wisdom to have a budget. Praise the Lord. So as Pastor said, I work for an insurance company, Transamerica Retirement Solutions. We do different things, but my area of specialty is actually retirement planning, defined contribution plans. So my role is, or my job is, to manage companies' retirement plan. I basically meet with the C-suite, so the CEO, the CFO, the COO, and human resource directors to review their plans, make sure it's working well for their employees. Currently, I manage 64 plans and assets of about $560 million. Praise the Lord. So when you see me driving and flying to Fresno and back, and you know, that's what I do. I go meet with those people, the decision makers of those corporations, and basically we talk about what can be done to enhance their plan to make sure that the ultimate purpose of the retirement plan is for the employees to retire. So we meet and we talk about how to make sure the information is getting to the people and that the employees are truly going to retire. Because unfortunately, if your employees don't retire, it's an expense to you as an organization. It costs you more and more to have people who are elderly and healthcare costs. Nothing against the elderly, but we want to make sure you retire. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. So I put something up here. It's not very clear, but there's something called a broker check online. For what I do, one of the requirements is that you have to have certain licenses, because what I do is it's governed by the IRS and the Department of Labor ultimately. So broker check is something that I thought, hey, you know, you can look up anybody, because I know some of you are working in organizations where you do have certain retirement plans, and you know, you might not know the advisor in the plan, and you might not know their capacity, what they've done wrong in the past, what they're doing currently. And that broker check, when you go in there, you key in any name. So I just put in my last name, Alade, and my California, and you can see it says 14 years of experience, because that's based on how long I've been licensed. It shows my licenses, exams that I've passed. I have a California state license. I'm actually a licensed insurance agent, although I don't sell any insurance. Praise the Lord. That's another passion. After budget, insurance. If you really want to get me excited, come talk to me about insurance. Hallelujah. So we're talking about budgeting, the power of change. I'm going to try to make this interactive. So when I say budgeting, what do you think is a budget? Just feel free to raise your hand and let me know what you think is a budget. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody's got to be budgeting. Sister Justina. Hallelujah, praise the Lord, you nailed it. A budget is basically how you want to, it's a management plan of how you intend to use your resources. Hallelujah. Okay, it's one of the ways we manage our finances to show that we are good kingdom stewards, right? Because we are kingdom citizens, and as citizens, we have a responsibility that is assigned to us, and the finances is one of those areas that we need to manage. We need to manage it effectively. Praise the Lord. So it helps us to make small spending changes that can make a big difference in our savings and in our lives, especially in our financial well-being. Why do we even talk about budgets? One of the reasons is because budget is related to money and management. This is really small, so I'll read it out to you. If you want to open your Bibles to Proverbs 10, verse 4, I'm going to read it. The NIV version says, "Lazy hands make for poverty, but diligent hands bring wealth." And when you look at diligence in the dictionary, it actually means management. So the purpose of a budget, like she said, is to manage something, your finances, right? So we need to show that we are not going to be lazy with what God has given unto us. The Bible says that the earth is the Lord and the fullness thereof. Hallelujah. So everything that is in the world is God's. But he commits certain things to you, which you have to manage. To you and to me. Right? Part of what he commits unto us is our finances. So we need to show to God that we are good stewards. Hallelujah. Now some people think that by prayer that they can prosper, right? because we said thou shalt prosper. I don't know if you've ever seen people who pray, God, give me money. Unfortunately, God doesn't answer those prayers. Praise the Lord. Because God doesn't use money, right? If you read the Bible, it talks about the, you know, heaven, the streets of heaven is made of what? Gold. So if in heaven the streets are made of gold, what does God have to do with your dollar? It's paper. Do you understand? Your paper dollar has no value. It actually used to have value until they took off the gold that was in reserved against the dollar. So now it's just paper. It's just paper currency that the government can print, and they keep printing it. You know, if you go online, you search the U.S. debt calculator, you'll see every day the thing is growing. You know, because they keep printing money. You hear in 2008, they talked about things to bring us out of the financial crisis. One of the things they talked about was quantitative easing. It sounds very good and pleasant. Really, all it means is they were printing money to try to get us out of the problem. But really, they are postponing the responsibility or the issue onto future generations. Do we understand that? So we as parents and grandparents and uncles and aunties and sisters, we need to learn this concept and teach them onto our kids so we don't continue the cycle repeating the same issues. Hallelujah. So prayer does not cause you to prosper. Please tell your neighbor, prayer does not cause you to prosper. Let them know, neighbor, you cannot pray your way into prosperity. Hallelujah. So the Bible says in Proverbs 13:4, it says, lazy people want much but get little. This is the New Living Translation. But those who work hard will prosper. King James Version says, the soul of the sluggard desireth and hath nothing, but the soul of the diligent shall be made fat. So the soul of the diligent, which means someone who manages, shall be made fat. So if you're not managing your wealth, guess what? You're not going to be fat. It's good to be fat in certain areas. I know. We talked about losing weight in the physical. But in our finances, we want to be fat and flourishing. You want to have enough unto every good work. Hallelujah. You know? Another reason that we talk about budgeting is that we need to learn how to be an economist. There are people out there that they study how the business cycle works, and they tell you, you know, inflation is this, and government is going to cut interest rate and things like that. Those are economists. But you don't have to go to university and get a degree to be an economist. With the money you have, you can be an economist. Basically, that means you're going to get the maximum use out of what you have. Okay? Economizing does not mean being, what's the word? Miserly? Is that the right word? Yeah, it's not being miserly. It just means you're an efficient manager, right? You're getting the maximum use. For example, I'll use my auntie here as an example. You know, she's a homemaker. And a few months ago, I noticed she was bringing snacks to church. I don't know if you guys know that. Mrs. Olowa here. So when you come out of church, you are hungry, right? And guess what? There's a snack available for purchase. That's someone making maximum use. You understand? She has tools in her house. She has a flour. She has salt. I don't make food like that, so I might say the wrong ingredient. But she basically combined it together. She created something, right? So she's maximizing what she has. Praise the Lord. So also, when we are managing our money well, we learn to maximize. We learn to figure out, assign something to every dollar. Every dollar that you have coming in, you're going to give it an assignment. Okay? And if you don't have the dollar coming in, you create an avenue for the dollar to come in. That's what she did. She created an avenue. We have a sister in the house, Sister Shebi. She's not here right now. And, you know, she wasn't working for some time. She was looking to get into her career, which was accounting. But in the meantime, she didn't just sit and be praying that, God, I'm going to become an accountant. She was studying. While studying, she decided, I'm going to start braiding hair. And she started braiding hair. You understand? She doesn't have a job as in J-O-B getting a salary, but she created an avenue for income. She maximized what she had, her skill. And she was able to exchange that skill for dollars. Hallelujah. So that is what it is to be an economist. You are basically, you know, taking charge and getting the maximum use of the minimum. Proverbs 12:27. It says, lazy people don't even cook the game they catch. That's New Living Translation. But the diligent make use of everything they find. Praise the Lord. Another version says, a lazy man does not roast his prey, but the precious possession of a man is diligence. Praise the Lord. So talking about diligence, excuse me, I started having this cold like 2 days ago. But I know I'm healed in Jesus' name. I have what? Yeah, thank you. Thank you so much. Okay. So we talked about there's a relationship between money and management. Management means diligent with resources. You cannot pray your way into budgeting or into prosperity. And you have to be an economist. Another reason we budget is because we want to grow our capacity. Hallelujah. And my note here says, God does not encourage waste. Answered prayer is regulated by what we can manage. So God watches what we manage, and if we handle it well, he gives us more. Hallelujah. Proverbs 21:5. It says, the plans of the diligent lead to profit, as surely as haste lead to poverty. Hallelujah. So, budgeting is a plan, right? A plan to manage something, which is your resources. So as you make those plans, you're basically realizing, okay, this area I can adjust here, this area I can grow here, and so on and so forth, and you grow your capacity that way. Praise the Lord. So for example, if I realize that I'm in my budget, and we're going to get more practical tomorrow, we're actually going to write a budget before you leave, okay? So this is just the theoretical aspect of budgeting, just to give us the idea of why we even want to go through this exercise in the first place. So, you know, if I realize, okay, I'm spending so much amount in groceries, let's say, for example, my grocery budget is 500, and I realize that, you know, I can actually be more efficient shopping in certain shops to cut things down, maybe buying in bulk, you know. For example, I know a lot of us we share cow, right? Instead of going to Mepiblo and buying beef, $5 per pound, you call a few friends, gather 8 of you together and say, okay, let's go get a cow, share it. The meat you get from that, it lasts you a longer time, right? So by doing that, you are basically making maximum use, right? You're making maximum use, and you're able to cut down the excess that you would have paid to the store by going to the store every so often. That amount you can then put in another area, invest it, or do something else with it and cause it to grow that way. Praise the Lord. So it helps us to grow our capacity. Now, one of the reasons we're talking about budgeting is that statistics says that 68% of people don't budget. Okay? So don't feel bad if you've never really wanted to do it. You know, a lot of people don't do it. And what that means is that because they don't budget, 78% of Americans live paycheck to paycheck. In fact, the only reason I started budgeting was that when I started working, I found that the day I got paid was a good day. You know, it was a really good day. And the second day will be good. And the third day will be good. But by the fourth day, I would just realize, what happened to all that money that came in? I didn't know. The money was just, you know, when the Bible says that money has wings and it flies away, the money was really flying. I had no clue where it was going. So I ended up having to sit down and start writing down what I'm using the money for. I mean, it got so bad. I will have some bills coming and I will have no money left. And I just got paid like 3 days ago. So I had to sit down and really devise a plan of, okay, you know what? This is one paycheck. I used to get paid on the 15th and the last day of the month. And this is the other one. And basically sit down and divide my expenses into two. Divide the bills and figure out when I get paid on the 15th, I'll use that paycheck to address these ones. When I get paid on the last day of the month, I'll use that one to address the other half. And that was how it started. And that was about 15 years ago. And over time, things have improved and improved and improved. And I started off just basically trying to balance everything and eventually got to the point where we could take some out and actually put it in investment so it can grow. Hallelujah. Sometimes people say, well, I don't have money. So why do I even, you know, I don't make enough money. So why do I even need a budget? I just need to make more money, you know. I'm working $12 an hour. I just need to make more money. Well, that's not true. Money is not your problem. Praise the Lord. Look at your neighbor and look at them very well and ask them, am I sitting next to a millionaire? Hallelujah. I want to say for the majority of us working here, and I say the majority of us because there are some youths who are not working yet, money is not the issue, because if you look at your tax return in the last 15 years, you've made $1 million. Does anybody agree with me on that? Do you think you've made $1 million? Raise your hand. I just want to see. I want to see how many of us are in that club. We've made $1 million. You see? So the money is not it's not like you didn't have money. It's just that you don't know where it went. Now, some of that money, for those of you from Nigeria, went to Nigeria. Hallelujah. Right? Some people are nodding there. So money, the lack of money is not the problem. You can go online, look at your socialssa.org, social security statement, and it actually shows you how much money you've earned in the last maybe 10 to 15 years. And you will be shocked the amount of money that has passed through your hands. Praise the Lord. Has anyone done that before? I encourage you, go to ssa.org. You know, they used to mail those statements out before, and they don't mail it anymore. ssa.org, you register, you log in, you will see. If you've done your 20, even if you haven't done your 2016 taxes, what was on your W-2 from your employer, you know, has already registered. So it shows that you have money, but lack of management is what has caused you not to know where the money has gone. Praise the Lord. The Bible says in Proverbs 13:22, it's one of the scripture I love. It says, a good man leaves an inheritance to his children's children, and the wealth of the sinner is laid up for the just. Praise the Lord. If you do not leave an inheritance, not for your children now, for your grandchildren, then you need to repent. Because the Bible says a good man leaves an inheritance to his children's children. Hallelujah. It might just, now, when I say inheritance, I don't mean like you leaving your clothes or your shoes. Those, you know, those are latest now, but like my mom is there. She has a lot of laces. But all those laces, 10 years from now, they're not going to be relevant. My daughter is not going to wear them. Praise the Lord. A tangible inheritance. Hallelujah. When your children are getting married, you don't want to just say, oh, I'll pay for the wedding. You want to give them a house. Say, here's an inheritance for you. Do you understand? Hallelujah. We have the capacity to do that. Other cultures are doing it. You know, Greeks do it. Italians do it. I work with them. I see them. Jews, they do it. So, and we are all working in the same America. It's not different. The soil is the same. And you are even a child of the kingdom. So you really have no excuse. Hallelujah. So I want to encourage all of us, you know, tomorrow when I talk more, tomorrow we'll go into the nitty-gritty. How do I create this budget that we're talking about? Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Thank you.
Hallelujah. Let's put our hands together for Sister Fumi Alade. Amen. Did you get anything tonight? That's just the tip of the iceberg. Tomorrow we're going to go more into it. And I tell you, I'm already readjusting my medulla oblongata as I'm sitting there. I say, you know what? There are some things, you know, you must put things in proper perspective. It's very, very important. It's not that we don't have the money. It's not that money are not passing through. It's not passing through our hands. But how do we manage it? And I know that by Sunday, I tell you, you know, some things will change in your life. Praise the Lord. You know, and you will testify in Jesus' name. You know, so you know, we are going on tonight, and part of managing is given to God. Praise the Lord. And I think maybe Sister Fumi or any of them, you know, they will, part of these, they're going to talk about that too. Not that God's kingdom should suffer because we want to do, especially is that one that is more important. And a lot of us, we have been you know, a practitioner of that, and you will know that we're not just talking it because we are privileged to be in front here. Any of you, you know, can experience that too in a practical form. In a very, very practical form. So God is no respecter of man when it comes to that. Praise the Lord. You know, so tonight we want to give our offering before we go into the next program, which is the last message for today from our guest speaker. You know, I want you to package your offering. If you are watching us online, please go to the donate button and give your tithe, give your offering tonight, as Sister Mami Afon is in the house. She's in the house. She's going to be ministering to us. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. And please, a lot of us don't have this CD. This CD is called Idima. It's a powerful CD. I know Sister Mami is coming out with another CD very soon. I saw a clip of that on YouTube, and I know they are working on that. Idima, you know, this is from our brother here. He's not even a brother, he's a pastor, he's a reverend. His wife, you know, is an apostle. She's an apostle, you know. John Opara has a CD. The CD is $10. You know, I have a copy. I tell you, if you get these and you play it in your car, you will enjoy it. I'm not just making out. It's a very good song. Let's encourage them. You know, buy it. $10 is with the ushers. You know, sow it into somebody's life too, and you will be blessed in Jesus' name. Let's welcome Sister Mami Afon. We're going to get our offering while she's giving us one special number, you know, before we call on the guest minister. Let's put our hands together for Sister Mami.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I am so glad to belong to this family. And Pastor Amy, I just want to honor you for your visionary leadership. It takes somebody who can understand the importance of unleashing potential in people and really calling out the gold in people. It takes a very special person. It takes somebody who has vision to do that. So I really want to honor you and Pastor Comfort for your visionary leadership for this church. And I believe that as we take those practical steps, one of my favorite lines from Joyce Meyer says, "Sometimes as Christians, we are so heavenly minded, we have no earthly use. And I think it's about time we transform that mindset in the church, that it's just about prayer and kaboying and kabaying, you know. But we have to be of, have the Bible says, let it be done on earth as it is in heaven. So it's not let it be done in heaven, you know, let it be done on earth as it is in heaven. So that's the order. We have to obey the dress code and the code of conduct. Amen. So I want to sing this song, The Power of Your Love. Amen. Thank you. Hold me close. Let your love surround me. Bring me near. Draw me to your side.
Draw me
to
me close. Come on, church. Let your love surround
about the glorious God. Glorious God, excellent King, beautiful King, we bow before your throne. Come on, help me sing. Glorious God, beautiful King,
the glorious
hey,
God.
We bow.
Bow before your throne.
Worship.
Worship at your feet.
Hold on.
Bow before your throne. You're the glorious God.
Let the heavens
bow before.
Bow before
your throne.
Worship
at your feet.
What a wonderful God.
Bow before your throne.
You are, you are.
The glorious God.
Oh,
your throne.
at your feet. We bow before glorious God. You are the glorious God. Beautiful King, hallelujah. Excellent God. That's the kind of God we serve, church. I don't know about you. He's such a glorious God. He's so beautiful in this place. Excellent in all your ways. We bow before your throne. My glorious God. He's the lover of my soul. He's so excellent in all his ways. He's mine. He's the King of Kings. He's the Lord of Lords, Alpha and Omega. We bow at the mention of your name. We bow before your throne. Bow, bow before your throne. Hey, come on, worship the worship. We bow before your throne.
Lift up your hands and worship him. Sing a new song to the glorious God. Excellent God. The King of Kings. The Lord of Lords. El Shaddai. El Elyon. The Prince of Peace. Galilee of the Valley is his name. Worship him. Worship him. It's beautiful beyond description. Too marvelous for words. El Shaddai. El Elyon, El Adonai, the Lily of the Valley, Kalabuli Atondele Atata, Brandali Atonde Asa, Kondole Boli Adado Sheliata, Kalamunde Lia Sopragiliada, Sendelebo Sheliata, Kandubaluata, Zengaliata, Seku Pragilian Delebo Sheliata.
We worship you, Lord. Oh, you're worthy to be praised. You're worthy to be exalted. We praise your name. Oh, we thank you, Lord. We praise your name. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, we have worship. In Jesus' name, we have worship. Father, we thank you. We return all the glory and praise to you. The reason why you spared our life and you created us is to pleasure you in praise. Father, let the sacrifices of our lips be acceptable before you tonight. In the name of Jesus. Lord, we lay ourselves at the altar of sacrifice. That you will accept us tonight in the name of Jesus. That you will accept our offering tonight. That these be used for the furtherance of your kingdom. For every giver tonight, give back to us in good measure. Pressed down and shaking together. That will be our portion in Jesus' name. Father, we thank you. We give you all the glory. In Jesus' matchless name, we have prayed. If you're in the house tonight, say louder, amen. Amen. Sister Mommy, anytime you minister, you bring down the glory. Amen. Anytime you minister, you bring down the glory. Something just break loose in the spiritual realm. Praise the Lord. May the Lord continue to anoint you in Jesus' name. You ain't seen nothing yet.
Bigger platform is coming, and God will take you higher and higher in the name of Jesus. Let's put our hands together again for Sister Mami. The Lord bless you. Anytime she just opens her mouth, whatever she sings like this, you know, the heaven is open. Amen. Amen. The man of God said, do you need to introduce me? I need to go right now because I'm the atmosphere I'm feeling now. Praise the Lord. But we still need to introduce the man of God that is in our midst tonight to minister. You know, we want to follow protocol, and I want you to, you know, be expectant, be open, because I know definitely, just like, you know, you receive little from what Stafumi shared, you're going to receive more, and tomorrow we add more, then on Sunday we cap it out. Praise the Lord. You know, tomorrow we enter the first day of the month, or the fourth month. And Jesus' house, Antioch, is going to be 13 years old from tomorrow. Tomorrow is our month, so this church is becoming a teenager. We have entered into our teen. Praise the Lord. So, I'm inviting all of you to an Holy Ghost party on Tuesday, which is our anniversary. That day, we are clocking 13. That's the 4th of April. Amen. We started this ministry on the 4th of April, 2004. And just like that, 13 years is passed. But we thank God where God has brought us. We thank God where we are from, where we are today. It's cool only because. So please, on Tuesday, everybody, I'm inviting you here. There's going to be food. There's going to be dancing, singing. So it's Holy Ghost party. Praise the Lord. It's not easy to become a teenager, right? So we are inviting you. Come and party with us on Tuesday. And that day also, we're going to break bread. We're going to break Holy Communion, you know, which is our first Tuesday, our family Tuesday. And it coincides with the birthday of the church. So it's not a coincidence. It's a God incidence. Praise the Lord. Please bring your family that Tuesday, because something is going to be released in the spirit in the name of Jesus. You know, the man of God that is ministering to us tonight, you know, I want us to, let's watch.
With a Jesus House applause, let us welcome Pastor Gbenga Showunmi. Pastor Gbenga is an insightful speaker, author, book publishing strategist, and business startup coach. He is a senior pastor of Destiny Star International Church, Houston, Texas, and CEO of Cornerstone Creativity Group, LLC, and Cornerstone Publishing. As a third-generation successful and award-winning entrepreneur, Gbenga has helped lots of businesses take off from scratch, and many see him as a leading authority in raising and shaping new entrepreneurial minds. Pastor Gbenga Showunmi is a prolific writer and author of 15 best-selling books, including In Pursuit of Greatness, The Prosperity Mindset, Moving Forward in the Storm, Your Supernatural Inheritance, and Prophetic Prayer for Divine Intervention. Pastor Gbenga is a graduate of Masters of Divinity from Oral Roberts University, Tulsa, Oklahoma. His life's mission is to help people move forward, achieving God's purposes for their lives. He is a loving husband and proud father of 3 Destiny children. He and his family reside in Houston, Texas. Pastor Gbenga, you are welcome once again to Jesus House Antioch, the house of praise and hope where victors are raised.
Hallelujah. Let's put our hands together as I welcome Pastor Gbenga. Hallelujah. Please put your hands together. Hallelujah. This man of God, I'm trying to, I just wrote 2 books, and he inspired me to write, and he's still pumping me. So he's written 15. And before the end of this year, I want to surpass him. Is it possible? Praise the Lord. And I know that he's an entrepreneur, and everything he's going to be teaching you this today, tomorrow, and Sunday, I know you will never remain the same again. Bless you, sir.
Thank you, the bishop. Hallelujah. Let's put our hands together for Jesus. Amen, amen. I have been enjoying the presence of God. Praise the name of the Lord. Amen. It's so, you know, when we're worshiping as a pastor, you don't have to introduce me. Let's just move in this atmosphere. It's so wonderful. And Sister Mami, God bless you and your ministry. You know, I encountered her on YouTube. I was looking for Olorun. I wanted to really sing that song on autoplay all through the day. I don't know, for some reason I woke up with that song and I said, I have to play it on YouTube while I'm working all day. And I was looking for different version. And she started talking about it that, you know, she first of all had the song from Pastor Yemi, Jesus House Antioch. I said, I know Pastor Yemi. Praise the name of the Lord. I said, okay, that is the song I'm actually looking for. I will stay with this one. So I you know, just put it, you know, play over and over and over again. Amen. God bless you. Really good. If I were to be in California, you have to be walking with me everywhere. You better come to Houston. Praise the Lord. Amen, amen. Amen. Our sister Fumi has given a wonderful teaching. Isn't that wonderful? Amazing. Amen. You know, I was in your house. Where is she? Oh, she moved? Why are you relocated? So, you know, I was in your house when we came for the birthday, right? Yes, you traveled. Amen. So you are blessed in Jesus' name. It's always a pleasure to be here again. Hallelujah. Pastor Yemi and Pastor Comfort, God bless you. Listen, it's not many pastors that will put this together. I've been pastoring for over 20 years, in ministry for over 22 years or so. I'll tell you, some pastors rather put their members in captivity. Just keep coming for deliverance. Come for deliverance. You do deliverance this Thursday. You come for deliverance another Thursday. Come for another deliverance. When are you going to ever be delivered? Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. So, you know, we have to put in principles of the kingdom, principles of God. Until I started understanding principles, things never shift in my life. I can pray. I can show you prayer with fire. Okay, but when you start praying with understanding and with the principle of the word of God, it makes a big difference. It makes a big difference. Sister talk about budgeting and planning. You know, when you budget and plan and you pray with a purpose, because you have a plan that you are praying on. Amen. You're not praying in a vacuum. Okay? You're not praying in a vacuum. You're not praying in motion. Alright? After you have killed all the enemies, please pray blessing upon your life. Amen. After you have killed all the enemies, when are you ever going to declare God's blessing and claim God's blessing and declare God's blessings? That's why my prayers is always from the point and from the perspective of the prophetic. Let us declare what the Calvary has already accomplished for us. Amen. We are already out of Egypt.
We're no longer in Egypt. So we have been delivered from darkness into his own marvelous light. So when are we going to ever start enforcing that which Christ has accomplished for us on the cross? You are not the poor trying to get rich. You are not the sick trying to be healed. By his stripes, ye are healed. Amen. But yes, when your body gets sick, all you need to do is to lay claim on that which Christ has already accomplished on the cross. Amen. So declare the word, what Christ has already accomplished on the cross. Your victory is there. Your riches is there. Your prosperity is there. Your healing is there. Your breakthrough is there. Your peace is there. Your joy in the Holy Ghost is there. So when you finish through emotion, pray all the negative, kill all the demons, kill all the enemies, kill all the friends and the ones that hate you, please don't forget to enforce the blessing. Because if you can enforce the blessing, he that is blessed cannot be cursed. Blessings and curses do not stay together. Darkness and light does not coexist together. So you need to understand this. Until you start living that way, Christianity is sweet. It's exciting. I'm telling you the truth. Hallelujah. I don't know if I've started preaching yet. Father, we thank you for tonight. We give you praise for what you have started already. We thank you for where we're going this weekend. Thank you for what you will do. We thank you for the heavens that are already open over our heads. We thank you, Lord, that you will show us the path to greatness in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, precious Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. So tonight I have the grace of teaching. Tomorrow is going to be more of training. How many of you wants to do business here? You want to have your own business? I think everybody, by Monday, everybody should be a business owner. At least in this church. And I will show you how tomorrow. It's not difficult. You should be a business owner. How many people are working two jobs? You have two jobs. You don't want to raise up your hand now. God knows you. Somebody here, you have two jobs. Okay, maybe you have three jobs. You have two jobs. Double shift. Amen. So my mission, and I know God's mission this weekend, is that you will be so loaded that you will never be stranded again financially in your life. I mean it, and I'm saying it with passion. Amen. That you will never be stranded again. Come on, if you're that person, say a bigger amen. That amen is still standing on one leg. Say amen. That I will never be stranded again financially. Never be broke again. Never. Because the pastor have set something in motion when he decided that this event has to hold, and it's called the financial and business summit. So I believe there's going to be a shift, and that shift is going to be a prophetic shift that would be in your favor,
in the direction of your prosperity and your greatness in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. 3 John chapter 2. But Jason, we're going to be very active tonight. Amen. So, because I feel the spirit to teach. Amen. Tomorrow training. Sunday is going to be preaching. Praise the Lord. So, please don't go. You're not going anywhere now. We're in the presence of God. Praise the name of the Lord. Amen. So because this weekend is loaded and, you know, we're going to take action. Praise the name of the Lord. Because faith cometh by hearing and hearing the word of God. And faith is an action word. If you hear the word and you have faith in the word, you must act it. The only way we know that you have faith is when you act it out. When they tell you you're going to get a job on Wall Street and you believe yourself that you're going to have a you're going to have a job or a business on Wall Street, you better start applying. Because that's how we know that you believe in what you said you believe. When you start doing it. It's not the hearer that is blessed, it's the doer of the word. It's the doer of the word. Is the door of the world. Action. Action. I'm more of an action person. If I know what is going to bless me and I get it, I go for it. I go for it. You know, some of you, you have time to pray and you ask God to do something for you. You have called the pastor, agree with me in prayer. And all of a sudden, when God said it is time, you say you are still praying. What are you still praying for? When God now opened the door for you, you say, Pastor, God has done it. He said, but pray whether it's the will of God. What will of God again are you looking for? It is the fear of taking action. I've been doing this thing, pastoring. They will come. We agree, we pray and believe God. And when the door opened, they said, Pastor, let's pray if this door is the will of God. I said, which other will of God do you need? Say, me, I know they pray again. No? I'm done. Don't pray. Praise the name of the Lord. Amen. Because some of us, you know, what you really need is action. And prayer is not going to take the action for you. Prayer can open the door for you. Prayer can help you with the open door. Favor comes upon you. And give you all the opportunity. But God will not move for you. You have to move. That's why our sister was talking about the diligence. The diligence bear the rules. The diligence always stay at the top. But the lazy one will not move. Praise the name of the Lord. Because by the virtue of this event, doors will be open. Financial doors will be open. Opportunity to go from where you are to where God has designed for you will be open in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. But you must move. You must be ready to move. You must be ready to move. When God was talking about the Israelites, as soon as it was time for them to leave Egypt, God said, rise, gird your loins, ready to move and rise on eagle's wings. So as they were taking the communion, they were taking it on their feet, guided, ready to go. Amen. So we must begin to be action people in Christianity. We have had so much. I'm believing God. Bless you. All this. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. You know all those things. Now it's time to act. You act the word of God. Amen. So this program this weekend will not do anything if you don't act on everything that we're going to be teaching you. We're going to be investing our time. Tomorrow I'm going to be teaching you business principles that will help you to start from your business from ground up. I've started 4 different businesses that are still successful. 4 different businesses. Okay? So even as I pastor a church, I have 4 businesses that I run. Did you understand that? So if you hire me to speak to you one-on-one, I know how much I will charge you.
No, yes, that is not true. Okay? So, but we're going to be here tomorrow. Amen? That business has to be given birth to. Really, really. Yes, in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. Okay, 3 John chapter 2. Is it? Yeah, just 3 John 2, not chapter 2. Amen. Now, are we there? Are you there? We're going to put most of the scripture up to it. Praise the name of the Lord. Amen. We already know what it is, right? Beloved. Amen. I wish above all things that thou mayest prosper and be in health, even as thy soul prospereth. God is the God of prosperity. And God is a God of prosperity. Is a God of abundance. God is a God of money. Amen. Again, chapter 1, I think verse 18 says, silver is mine and gold is mine. Silver is mine and gold is mine. When Jesus was given the parable of the talent in Matthew chapter 25, it was not a talent as in gifting or skill. It was a talent in time of money that he spent at that time. Gave one 5 talent, another one 3 talent, 2 talent, another one talent. And he expect them to come back with profit. You see, most of the parable of Jesus talk about money. Praise the name of the Lord. Whenever church people call me and say, Pastor, pray for me. I say, well, pray that God bless me. What 89% of the time is that God pray for something that relates to money. Amen. How many of you are here that you have not spent money today? Praise the name of the Lord. So it's one thing that you live with. 8 hours of your day is given in exchange for money. Praise the name of the Lord. So you can pay the bills, right? Amen. So money is so very critical to your life. I'm telling you the truth. The people who don't get money or who are poor are the people who criticize the people who have money. Anytime I see people who criticize, oh, she's flying jets. He's flying jets. He's, oh, why is he wasting all that money on business class? Why is it doing that? It's because you don't have the money. When you work and you earn your money, praise the name of the Lord, don't tell me how to spend it. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. Because money is so critical to your life, to your family. Our sister just said, a responsible man, a good man, a righteous man will leave inheritance for his children's children. My grandmother died 2 years ago. Is it 2 years now? I can't remember again. Yes, 2 years ago. Yes, 2 years ago. About 2 years ago. And but before she died, my grandmother is a farmer. Was a farmer. She has cocoa farm. She has kola nuts. But this time she has some money. She said, buy all this kola nut and store it for me. In case anything happened, because she started seeing signs. Store it. Say, this is for my grandchildren. Praise the name of the Lord. Apart from all the cocoa farm that she had, she only gave birth to my dad. And my dad has already gone. Amen. So when she sat down with me, she said, Gbenga, when I died, God will put money in your hand. And she specified things that I will do.
She said, don't worry, you will have money. And all of a sudden, I got all these contracts that keep coming to me. And I was wondering, why? I was telling my wife, this money that is coming to my hand must be for some reason. Boom, I heard that my grandmother passed away. As soon as they come here, I said, to God be the glory, I smile. So when I got home, and they were saying that, oh, they still need this, they still need that. And some people say, we don't have money. I said, that is fine. Amen. Say that is fine. By the time they start seeing things showing up in the village, you see, money answers all things. The wisest man that lived in the Bible, the richest, Solomon, says money answers all things. Praise the name of the Lord. There is none of you that go to this grocery store and you get to the cashier and you are speaking in tongue to pay. Amen. You didn't speak in tongues. Praise the name of the Lord. You paid money. Amen. I have known the difference between not having money, being lack, disgusted and busted, and having much for myself, for my family, and to give to others. The difference is clear. Some of us, the kind of headache that we have is not natural. It is because you have all this bill piling up and all this debt piling up and all this credit card piling up and the rent is coming or the mortgage is coming. Then you develop some kind of headache from nowhere. Amen. Telling you, when somebody appear and give you money, the headache will just automatically disappear. You don't need time enough for that. Praise the name of the Lord. Because money answers. Money answers. Money is not all things, but money answers to all things. Praise the name of the Lord. So there is something that prosperity and poverty has in common. Mindset. Everybody say mindset. The prosperous person has a mindset and the poverty also have a mindset. I always say something. Poverty is not lack of money. Sometimes. Most of the time is the lack of knowledge or access to money. And sometimes the knowledge is there, but the wrong appropriation of the knowledge or not even making use of the knowledge kept a lot of people in poverty. The prosperity mindset. That's why I wrote this book, and I'm going to be teaching most of what I'm teaching today is in this book. Amen. I'm going to talk about it later. The prosperity mindset. There are people that they are not Christian. They will never be poor. It's not a curse. They will never be poor. Because their mindset is already fashioned. Okay? In prosperity. They have abundance mindset. They just believe that it doesn't matter where you put them. Whatever they do, they will succeed financially. Praise the name of the Lord. There is what is called wealth quotient. If the mindset that you have, or the knowledge that you have, or the capacity that you have. My sister was talking about the capacity to earn. So if the capacity that you have can only contain thousands of dollars, that is all that you can have. Because as far as you're concerned, you can't imagine yourself having a million. The people who have millions of dollars think in terms of million. The kind of association they have is the association of millionaires. The kind of thinking that they have is fashioned like a millionaire kind of thoughts.
They are world-class thinkers. As a man thinketh in his heart, so he is. So it is a mindset thing. I grew up in poverty. I seen lack. You know, those days I run to my dad. Oh, they say we should bring this from school. Well, I don't have money for it. I feel so terrible, so bad. So why is it that my dad doesn't have money for everything that I ask? And other children, they will come with textbook, come with everything to school. Me, only exercise book. Praise the name of the Lord. No, I'm not trying. My dad did his best. Praise the name of the Lord. But I'm saying that was my upbringing. And I grew up with that kind of upbringing that I don't think I will ever be prosperous in my life. Amen. Because that is all that I know. So lack all the time. So I speak lack. I see lack. And anytime, even when I have opportunity for financial breakthrough, I'm afraid. Praise the name of the Lord. And some of you, you're saying, now you are there. Yeah. Amen. But there's a breakthrough coming for you. Yeah. In the name of Jesus Christ. Because it's a mindset thing. When you begin to think beyond where you are right now, what you are handling right now, your paycheck right now, that you don't, on Sunday I'm going to be talking about that. You don't live according to your paycheck. Your paycheck is not your source. God is your source. And he will give you abundance according to his riches in glory in Christ Jesus. So as long as you continue to live, that this my paycheck is all that I have in order to succeed. You plan based on your paycheck. Everything about your imagination is by the scope of your paycheck, not on the God factor. And once you live like that, you are trapped and you are stuck financially for life. And that's why you complain. That is all that I have. I can't do more than that. I can't do more than this. So there's something in common. Poverty mindset and the prosperity mindset. Number two thing in common is God's, the Bible says in Proverbs 22 verse 2 that the rich and the poor, God created them both. Praise the name of the Lord. So, that doesn't mean that God created the poor. It just means that they make a choice. Amen? So, some people make a choice to be rich. And some people make a choice to be poor. Praise the name of the Lord. So, people make a choice. I personally have to sit myself down. When I say sit myself down, I sat myself down and had a meeting with myself. Say, Gbenga, come here. Do you want to continue like this? Amen. Hallelujah. The people who made millions, they don't have two heads. Amen. They are also created by God. I'm also created by God. But I can make my own choice and carve out my own destiny because I'm the champion of my destiny. So I called myself and bombarded myself with so much thought about prosperity from the word of God. The third thing that people always say is that Jesus says that the poor you will always have among you. Amen. So you choose to be the poor. And when Jesus was actually saying that, he was saying it to his disciples, was saying it to Christians, was saying it to his followers. So that the poor you will always have around you. In other words, he was talking to his followers that you are not the poor, but there are people who will be the poor, they will be among you. And if you believe that you are the poor among, why can't you change camp? Amen. So tonight, tonight, we must decide and say, right from today, I can never be poor again. The day we, my wife and I and two children, we became homeless with the clamors. I was pastoring church. I was a really proper pastor. Praise the name of the Lord. I went to preach. After preaching, come back. I met 72 hours notice by the sheriff. We are evicted. Called the landlord, begged, say no, Gbenga, you have to leave. Because we couldn't pay our rent. So, loaded, I went and get a truck. We loaded all everything. My wife and I, we pack. Say no, we won't see any sheriff come and throw our stuff out. We loaded the truck. Then the court say we should go to social services. Go to social services. I'm telling you this, the reason is because, you see, when you see some of us tomorrow, you need to know where we began from. I'm not that pastor that will tell you that we're all here. We move from somewhere, from glory to glory. And you are shifting base too, from glory to glory. If God can do it for me, he will do it for you. From there, I can own my own businesses. God can do it for you. Because tonight is to challenge us. So we went and we sat with the officer in social services. And after so many, we went so early, my children in pajamas, so little. The other one was in the car seat. And when we got there, I've never seen that kind of place in my life. People smoking early morning, smoking all kinds of things. You know, I mean, the whole place was smelling alcohol. And we in the midst of pastor, in the midst of those people. I carry Bible. I pray. So when my sister was saying prayer alone cannot do it, I know what she was saying. Yes, I'm telling you the truth. Decision to make a change in your life is what we do it. To say now, right from today, I cannot live this life again. There is a change that must come to my life. You hold it to yourself and your family to be wealthy. Write it down. You hold it to yourself and your family to be wealthy. You hold it to yourself and your family to be wealthy. You know, when I moved to Houston, I've never seen the high rate of beggars before in the United States like I've seen in Houston. In fact, one guy put the paper like this. He said, don't pray for me. I need money. I'm telling you. And I wanted to take the picture. He said, I don't need prayer. I need money. He said, don't pray for me. It's money that I need. On every road, on every junction, you see them. You hold it to yourself and your family to be wealthy. I'm telling you. So when you find yourself in the camp and they say the poor, you know, there are some places you will go. They'll say some people come here, they'll call them by their names. And they will say some people, others, others. I don't like being among others. Amen. So you are the one that will make the change. You have to make a decision. Amen. You have to make a decision, because until we start making that decision, that things have to change in our individual life, we don't see change. So many times we talk, 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 But the action that is necessary for the change, I come like a coach today, is not taken. You know what needs to be done. But sometimes, is that something is holding you back from taking action. Tonight, this weekend, there will be a shift in your life. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Poverty is a curse and does not glorify God. And we're going to read some scripture right now. Because for me, that is what did it for me. You know, I told you I sat myself down, right? So let's see Proverbs 19 verse 4. Wealth maketh many friends. But the poor is separated from his neighbor. If you are poor, you are lonely. Nobody wants to associate with you. Because they see you as a liability. Praise the name of the Lord. Remember, there was a time in my life that I would be calling this person, oh, can you help me this? Can you help me that? Can you help me this? My wife said, when are you going to stop begging? She actually said that to me. When are you going to stop? Amen. Wealth maketh many friends. I'm telling you, just win a lotto today and say you won 10 million. I'm telling you, you see people who will show up, will say, don't you remember me? Don't you remember me? I am the brother, father, sister of your senior brother. The first time I show up in Nigeria, after arrive, you know, my first time coming to Nigeria, then when I visited Nigeria for the first time, people came from here, your brother. Your brother needs school fees. I say, my brother, which brother? I'm trying to figure it out. Suddenly, everybody in your community is your brother, sister. They are your uncle, they are your mother, they are your father now. They are your children. Amen. I say, omoyi. Oni udi owo lewe, omoyi. Your children. Amen. Suddenly all children in the community become your children. Everybody become your father. Everybody want to be your friend. Wealth makes many friends. I like making friends. Praise the name of the Lord. Wealth. The wealthy person that don't make friends are wicked wealthy people. If you are good, wealthy people, you will have good friends. In fact, one of the common thing about along wealthy people is that they will have best friend around them. Surround themselves with best friends. Go to social media today. Any wealthy person have high percentage of followers. Amen. You, how many do you have? You try. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. That's just the truth. Wealth makes many friends. But the poor is not known by his neighbor. You're on your own. That's what it means. That's why it's dangerous to be poor. Because you can die and nobody know about it. A man died in Bronx, New York. He was dead for several weeks in his house. And nobody knew that he was gone. Proverbs chapter 10 verse 15.
Proverbs 10:15. You must hate poverty with passion. Are you there? You're gonna help me. The rich man's wealth is his strong city. The destruction of the poor is their poverty. The rich man's wealth is his strong city. I heard that if you go to the community of people who are rich, there is more security, police patrolling that place, even guided, more than poor common neighborhood. Praise the name of the Lord. Because they recognize the wealth of that community. They recognize what that community is bringing to the government. The wealth, the riches of a man is a strong city. Build a strong city. But the destruction of the poor is the poverty. The spirit, destruction of the poor is his poverty. I was in Nigeria. I think Sister Justina just came back. She make a post on Facebook of people, pregnant women. Is it a sin? Is it a sin to be pregnant again? Pregnant, give birth, they couldn't pay. Right? They couldn't pay in Nigeria. And they were kept in maternity prison. That because they couldn't pay. Yes, now they won't go home. And God help you in C-section. Then it's next level. How many people have come from Nigeria? My wife had a C-section. They won't let her go. They only have 20,000 naira. They need 20,000 more. As a result, they keep them there and lock them up. The destruction, the poor, the destruction of the poor is what? It's poverty. If you have 40,000, just walk in there. 40,000. Okay, give my wife, I'm going home. It's as easy as that. Money answered what? All things. Amen. I wouldn't be homeless if I had money. You know the danger of homelessness. With children. Know how many sicknesses in the world can be cured in Africa if there is money. People die of diabetes that they shouldn't be dying of. It is because of lack of money for the cure. The destruction of the poor is his poverty. That's why we must. That's why I make that statement. You own it to yourself and to your family to be wealthy. Praise the name of the Lord. Next one, Proverbs 22:7. I'm saying something here because something has to shift. These are some of the scripture that I read and you say, oh, really? Are you there? Proverbs 22:7. Look at this. The rich ruleth over what? Over the poor. As long as that you want to remain poor, some people will be ruling over you. Poverty enslaves. And it's even worse when you have poverty mentality. Amen? When it becomes that you don't believe that you will ever break through financially. Then you subject yourself to all kinds of ruling. The rich always will rule over the poor. And the what? The borrower will become the servant to the lender. You know, a guy, his friend, you know, I just had that story. His friend was calling him with a different number for several times. And he will not pick up.
Then he eventually left a message. Hey, it's not IRS pursuing you or somebody trying to get money from you or trying to pursue you for the debt that you are owing. Just call me back. It's not the creditors. Some of you, some people, you receive some foreign number, you won't pick it up. Those people, I'm owing them. They're the one calling me. You know? Because a borrower is a servant to the lender. You see, the reason why God says to covenant people, thou shalt lend to many nations, thou shalt not borrow. I'm reading a book by a rabbi. Thou shalt lend to many nations. It takes nation to lend to nations. Amen. But thou shalt not borrow. The reason why it's so difficult to pay back is because you have not dealt with some things with you. An interest rate keep piling up. Bought a car for 20,000. But when you pay back, you pay 32,000. So when my sister was talking about, it's because you don't know where the money go. It has gone somewhere. Somebody somewhere sits down somewhere and just cross his leg with cigar in his hand and with a wine somewhere. And that person got extra $12,000 from you. I don't buy new cars. Praise the name of the Lord. At least not for now. Amen. Are you getting that? Now, let's now read the critical one. Ecclesiastes chapter 9, verse 14 to 16. I said, I feel like teaching today, so I'm taking it precept by precept. Let's go this route. Amen. Let us see it. Because revelation is very important. Praise the name of the Lord. Revelation is very, very important. Very, very important. Because what you know, is somebody say, what you don't know can kill you. But what you know can free you. You shall know the truth and will make you free. Not set you free. Make you free. You are built up. You are made free. You stay in the state of freedom because of that truth that you know. Are you there? Okay, let's go. Look at this. There was a little city and a few men within it, and there came a great king against it and besieged it and built great bulwark against it. Let's go on. Now there was found in it a poor wise man. I don't know why we are poor wise men, because wisdom is not synonymous to poverty. But somehow this man is wise, but as a mentality of poverty. Praise the name of the Lord. That's why you can be wise and still be poor. You can be anointed and still be poor. Nobody says, you know, anointing without money is annoyance. Amen. If you see some pastor, they don't have money, they are frustrated, they will just be cursing everybody. He get angry. I've seen a pastor like that, got angry. Just got angry, you with these people. Anointing without money equals annoyance. Don't meet annoyance, pastor. And that is why you need to make your pastor rich. There are pastors that are, listen, let me digress it. There are members, not you. I don't believe it's Jesus' house because I see Pastor Yemi all the time. Amen. But if it's you better repent. There are people who believe they should keep their pastor poor in order to keep him humble. Humble. If he wears a new shoe, they say, pastor. Things are happening, no? Praise the name of the Lord. When I say to pastors, I say, some of you members, you don't understand some grace that pastors carry. You may never be able to know it. Because the Bible said, if you serve me and obey me, you will spend all your days in prosperity. And I believe that when I'm serving God, it's God's responsibility to bless me financially. So don't think your pastor will come and beg you to fear, but it's not going to happen. And if you bring money to your pastor, it's for your own blessing. Don't come and say, I want to bless you, man of God. Who are you blessing? You say, man of God. You are doing this so he can bless you. Paul said, I don't need anything. He said, so that it can be to your own account. Say, for me, I'm good, I'm full. Say, but for your own account. For your own account. For your own account. Amen. Come on, say, I'm breaking forth. Come on, say, I'm breaking loose from every grip of poverty in my life and in my family. In the name of Jesus. Come and say it. I'm breaking loose from every grip of poverty in my life and in my family. Say it one more time and say, I'm breaking forth from every grip of poverty in the name of Jesus. Put that scripture up. We're still there. So the poor wise man, and he, by his wisdom, delivered the city. Yet, no man remembered that same poor man. He didn't even say that same man. He said that same poor. There is a reason why Bible puts some specific words. The guy is wise. Skillful. But nobody remembers it. Fixed what was wrong, and they forget him. We don't know you. The same thing goes. Nobody wants to associate themselves with poverty. So they abandon him. They say, thank you. But they ignore him. It's evil under the sun. Praise the name of the Lord. I don't like to be ignored. When I enter a place, I want people to know that I entered. Praise the name of the Lord. I have my favorite flowery shirt. When I'm traveling, I just say, I've been looking at you. I like your shirt. I like it. I like it when people give me compliments. I like it. You go to the store and dress tattered and like rag, and you're looking for help, nobody will help you. But just dress good and show up. I'm telling you. People say, how you doing, ma'am? Can I help you, ma'am? Amen. Are we having fun tonight? So this man did wonderful thing. Delivered the whole city, but they forget him. They were supposed to even have a decoration for him, an award for him, call for party for him, but they forgot him. Nobody remembered him because he was wise but poor. Poor. Poverty, when you are supposed to be remembered, people forget you. They belittled you, they put you on the side. When they call for family meeting, they call everybody, though they leave you out. Except if God intervened for you like David. Praise the name of the Lord. But the instinct of man is to leave out people who are poor, who they have taught will never amount to anything. They will leave them out of the most important thing that is supposed to happen in their life. Come on, say, change is coming to my life. We serve the God of prosperity. Our God is the God of gold. The heavens is made with gold, pure gold. I'm telling you, if you think prosperity is evil, then you mean God is evil. If you think money is evil, what you're saying is that God is evil, because he's the God of money. Silver belongs to him. Gold belongs to him. He's the owner of 1,000. He's the owner of cattle on 1,000 hill. The heart is the Lord and the fullness thereof. Ask and it shall be given to you. Who among you, when your children ask you for anything, you won't give it to them? See, if you have been evil, we give to your children, how much more me, the Father? How much more the God that has unlimited resources? Our God is the God of prosperity. Amen. Our God is what? A God of prosperity. He said, I pray that thou mayest prosper. That you should prosper. That you should prosper and be in earth, even as your soul prospers. So to the degrees to which you love God, to the degrees to which you live a holy life, to the degrees to which you live a righteous life, that you should experience prosperity to the same degrees. When I was growing up, I got born again in the SU. If you buy a new cloth, new shirt, it's like you are of the world. If you have money, you are of the world. Praise the name of the Lord. Wrong mindset. But the Bible says, declare that through prosperity shall my kingdom be spread. Money is not evil. It is people who are evil. Money is good in the hand of a good man, and you have a good woman. Money take up the personality of the person who is holding it. Money take up the personality of the person who has it. If you're a righteous person, you will do righteous thing with money. And because you do righteous thing with money, God will put more money in your hands. Praise the name of the Lord. But if you're a wicked person, you will do wickedness with money. Money take up the personality of the holder. Sometimes I get angry that the kingdom, the people of God, do not understand this. Do you know that everything, we're talking ISIS today, do you know that people are putting money in the hand of ISIS? No. There are people who it is their own responsibility to pump money into their camp. To service them with money in order to do evil. And those people who are servicing them with money, they will do anything. They will do business, sell oil, do enterprise, and do any other thing to get money in order to service wickedness. And you're a child of God. When they call for missionary for mission, you are not there. I don't have money. When they call, let us build a church, I don't have money. When they call, let us preach the gospel, I don't have money. What you have is prayer, right? Say, let us pray, let's pray, let's pray. Nigeria, let's pray, let's pray. All this Boko Haram. Let's pray. But some people are giving them money, and the enemy is using it to spread their agenda on earth. All that we have is prayer. No money or talk. When they gather for Owambe anywhere, you gather, you show up, you wear the best of the best. I even think that some certain camp in Yoruba land, they will conjure things when they have not do any party in a while. They will say, yes, we want to do their great-grandfather that have died several years. We want to turn our back. He's back. And they will organize a party. Spend money. Kingdom of God is suffering. We're praying. We're not preaching the gospel. Missionaries are suffering. No money. But there are people who they won't sleep, all because they want to service wickedness with money to spread their agenda. And you're there. Amen. So that's one of the reason why you need to prosper. The reason why you need to have money is so that, listen, if it's all the money you need for you and your family, you don't need much. Really, you don't really need much. Really, I mean, you have 3 kids, maybe 4, or maybe 5. And one of my younger brother just called me and say, I have another kid. I say, how many do you have now? He said, 5. I say, say it again. And he's the guy that doesn't have job, that doesn't have money, that always coming for needs. He added another one. He's busy having babies. You see the reason why the poor, you see, the reason why the poor will continue to get poorer. Yes. The poor continue to get poorer. And I will show you some scripture tomorrow when we're doing the business summit. The poor will continue to get poorer. Because look at that scripture. In Matthew chapter 25, of that servant that was given one. It was according, the Bible said they were given according to their several abilities. So the guy, God looked at him and said, this one, the way I'm looking at you, one. So that one was the only one that doesn't know how to multiply money. So the rich will continue to get richer by the same mentality or prosperity mindset, because the rich knows how to multiply money. One of the qualifications of being rich is to be able to multiply. You must have multiplication mindset. You must have what? Multiplication mindset. When you spend, don't spend for liability. Spend for asset. Don't spend for liability. Spend for asset. People who are rich and prosperous spend for asset. They don't spend for liabilities. The only thing they do in liability is to take care by insurance. My sister talked about insurance, by insuring their liabilities. Amen. So that it doesn't affect their wealth. So you must learn to multiply. Okay, I think I've skipped now to something else. Maybe let's just take it from there so that I can close. Amen. Because the God that gave us the power to get wealth, right? And if God gives you the power to get wealth, God must be able to trust you with wealth. God doesn't waste. So, the first thing is that you must work on yourself. Many times we don't work on ourselves. You must work on yourself. Your spending habit. That's why we're talking about budgeting. You must control your appetite. Amen. I used to have instant gratification. Okay? But I noticed that if I'm going to be blessed, I have to begin to have delayed gratification. So when I shift into delayed gratification, I begin to see God blessing me more. Amen. I begin to seek God's face for what I should buy and what I shouldn't buy. I begin to know what is more important, what is not important. Some of you have so much clothes in your house, so many shoes, and you're wondering, how many people, if you have clothes that you have not worn in 10 years, what is it still doing there? Praise the name of the Lord. So you must, for God to trust you with wealth, you must control your spending habit. Praise the name of the Lord. Giving you some principles now. Amen. You know? So don't be an impulse buyer, except it is going to make you more money. Except something is going to make you money. Buying stocks, buying to other business. The guy called me, want to buy, 1% of my business is $1,000. So, to sell. Amen. Increase your capacity to learn. Increase your capacity to learn. Some of these points I wrote them down. I think I just want to round up. Increase your capacity to earn. One of the greatest assets that you have is your ability to earn money. If you lost that ability, I have a couple that I know that within the space of 2 months, they lost their six-figure income. They live in God, have great house, great cars, and life happen. And that's why I'm coming to the third point. You must have multiple streams of income. Paycheck to paycheck will not cut it. Forget it. The best they will give you is another 3% next year. Every year, 3%. If you are single, you had a wife, and you are still based on 3%. You have added the whole human being to your family. And a child comes in, you are still on 3%. The second child, you are still living in one bedroom. Praise the name of the Lord. Every day your responsibility is getting bigger. But your income is capped. And that is why I'm not saying go look for a second job. That's not what I mean. When I talk about multiple stream of income, and that is why you have to be here tomorrow when we talk about business summit. By the time I did different business summit in our church, more than 80% of our members were having businesses. My sister was coming with, what do you come to church with? Snacks. Yeah, you come with chin chin. What? Meat pies. My. And all of you, after church, you give her money, and she service you. Money is a reward for service. Write that down. Money is a reward for service. You don't have anything to sell. You don't have money. Now, suppose your income fade out. What do you have? Amen. You must have another source of income somehow. Want to sell Mary Kay, sell Mary Kay. Praise the name of the Lord. If you want to, there was a woman those days, you do Mary Kay, and two of you sitting together, you're competing with each other. God will help you. Now I don't even know who to buy from. Amen. There was a woman, she started doing ogi in our church those days. She would package it. It's a pub, it's a camp. Cornflower. Different. Okay, you know, let me break it down for you. American grape, pudding. Okay, so she sell that. You understand what akamu ogi means, right? So she sells that. She will come to church and sell that. The other woman was doing chichi. You know, people started doing something. So selling something. Don't just base on paycheck. Praise the name of the Lord. When my wife got pregnant, after how many months, she couldn't walk again. She focused on America. She, by the way, she said America too. She focused on that. And that was really bringing good money for us. Praise the name of the Lord. So you need to have multiple streams of income. Diversify. That is how the rich make their money. Not through paychecks. Depends on that. After 2 weeks, you get the paycheck. By the time it's come, it's already gone. Amen. Then you tell the pastor, I couldn't pay my tithe because, you know, everything is gone. How can everything be gone? Amen. If I were your pastor, I'd say, God, you better go and start making money elsewhere too. You have to have business. When I have many people in our church, I ask them, what can they do apart from their paycheck? And they tell me what they can do. I say, I'll do free business card for you on that. And I'll take them to where they'll register the business. Okay? And they'll have, and I'll promise that I'll do 1,000 business cards for them. So they have business, they can go paycheck. One woman will go get a paycheck and come back in the evening and do braiding. Praise the name of the Lord. So in case the paycheck say, we are laying people off. You say, okay, no problem, I'll do full time. My braiding full time. Our business. So I think let's stand up here. Amen. Our God is a God of prosperity. Psalm 35, verse 27. Let's stand up here. Are you blessed tonight? You cannot be broke again. Are you there? I can read it actually. I opened it already. I just want everybody to see it. Are you there? 35 verse 27. 35:27. Let them shout for joy and be glad that favored my righteous cause. Yeah, let them say continually, let the Lord be magnified, which had what? Woo! Heaven celebrates when you are prosperous. God is happy when you are able to pay your bills. Heaven is celebrating when you are able to meet all your needs and you are able to give to the poor and you are able to support the gospel and you are able, you are not in any tension. You are not in any stress. Praise the name of the Lord. Let us rise on our feet. God has pleasures in the prosperity of his people. He has pleasures in the prosperity of his people. He has celebration. His delight is in your prosperity. Amen. His delight is in your prosperity. His delight is in your prosperity. Hallelujah. Let's lift up our hands tonight. What decision are you making? I must move forward. I must move forward. I must move forward. There must be a turnaround in my life. There must be a change in my life. There must be a transformation in my life. There must be a transformation. Transformation in my life. Transformation. Come on. Begin to tell yourself, I will not be poor again. I reject poverty. I reject it. It is not of me. It is not of God. It is not of me. It is not of God. It is not of me. It is not of God. It is not of me. I reject it for my children. I reject it for myself. I reject it for my home. In the name of Jesus, I am rich. I am rich in Christ. I am rich in Christ. Jesus, the Bible says he became poor so that through his poverty, did you hear that? 2 Corinthians chapter 8 verse 9, he became poor so that through his poverty you might become rich. There's a divine exchange. For we know the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, that though he was rich, yet for your sake he became poor, that ye through his poverty might be rich. Through his poverty you can be rich. You are not permitted to be poor. Your place is in the place of riches. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. So you're going to pray just one prayer tonight as we prepare to come tomorrow. Amen. I want you to hold somebody by the hands. Thank you, Lord. We're going to say, Father, in the name of Jesus, every curse of poverty in my life is broken in the name of Jesus. Father, in the name of Jesus, every curse of poverty in my life, in my family, I command it be broken in the name of Jesus. I want you to pray. Say, break it, destroy it to the roots in the name of Jesus. Destroy it to the root. Destroy it to the root. Destroy it to the root. Thank you, precious Father. We worship you, we give you glory, we magnify you, we honor you, Lord. Lika paruko sete brahadabasha reketo brakusita rikashida. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. You see, Psalm 118 verse 25. Save now, I pray. Oh Lord, I pray, send now prosperity. When? When? Come on, when? Tomorrow? Next month? Next year? Now! Send now prosperity. I want you to pray and say, Father, send now prosperity to my family, to my home, to my children, to my business. In the name of Jesus, send now prosperity to my ministry, to my church. Send now prosperity. Send now. Send now prosperity. Send now prosperity. Thank you, precious Father. Blessed be your holy name. We give you glory. We give you honor. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. It's going to be a miracle in this house. God is just showing me now. It's going to be financial explosion. Financial explosion that is coming. Financial explosion that is coming. If you make a decision for shift, it is coming to you in the name of Jesus Christ. You must increase your capacity to learn. One of the ways to do that, to earn more money, is to seek for knowledge. I'm telling you, we don't buy. I was coming today at the airport. I entered to a bookstore. I saw this book, The One Thing. Because I have so many things that I'm doing that this year I just want to fire myself and focus on one thing. Amen. I saw this book. Guess whose people wrote this book? Powerful people. And I bought it for $27. $27, this one. Amen. I have some powerful books like that in my library. And I've started reading it. Very good book. Great book. It's changing my life already. Some simple principles. If you can read, somebody read this book and call me and say, Pastor, I'm having a seminar this Sunday and I'm using your book. Everything I talk to you here is in this book and many more that I couldn't talk about. So get these books. In Pursuit of Greatness is a powerful. These are two, my newest book. So this one is $20. And this one is $15. You get two of them, you get it for $30. They are not that expensive. I'm not expensive. Praise the name of the Lord. Amen. But I'm telling you things that will change your life. So tomorrow is going to be business summit. And everybody should be here. It's going to be a long day. Are we going to have food? Something to eat? Okay. Alright. So let's be ready for that. Everybody should have a business, and I will tell you why. Amen. Because that has changed my life. There's dignity in having your own business and having command of your life. Praise the name of the Lord. You make your own profit and scale how much money you want to make. When you have your own business, you can determine your financial destiny by yourself. You can say, okay, through my business this year, I want to make 100,000. And if you can work on it and have a plan for it, it is possible. And by God's factor of grace and favor upon your business, you will go places. In Jesus' name, we want to raise business owners. Not just self-employer. We want to raise CEO of companies. Amen. You know, there are people who own business that don't own a company. Amen. You will have your own company and say, this, when you are giving out a business card, say, this is the business card of my company. It's different. It's different when you say, I'm selling kuli somewhere. You say, I have, this is the business of my company. Praise the name of the Lord. Amen. It's different though. And you can. Come on, say, I can. In Jesus' name. Amen. Father, we thank you for the rain. We declare open heavens. So people go tonight. We ask. The lines are falling onto us in pleasant places. We are good in heritage. And we are stepping into it. Stepping into our prosperity. Stepping into our blessing. Everyone here that have been deprived of what belongs to you. Tonight, Makusata Indre Gedebosha, Riku Prakisataita, Whatever belongs to you that has been held down, I release it right now in the name of Jesus. You shall not be broke again in your life in the name of Jesus. Heaven will fight for you and you will hold your peace. Right from today, abundance is your portion. That amen is sick. Right from today, abundance is your portion. You will not lack money. Money will pursue after you. You will not pursue after money. Money is called currency. And right from today, the currents of currency will move in your direction. In the name of Jesus Christ. You will not chase money. Money will meet money in your hand. It shall not be said again that I don't have. Because the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. You will not lack money. When anything call that you are supposed to show up with money, you will show up. You will show up with money in your hands. In the name of Jesus Christ. You will never be dispersed again. You will never be relegated again. You will never be pushed to the back again. Wherever you have been rejected before, because of this event, this program, this prophetic weekend, you will be called back and be celebrated in the name of Jesus Christ. So shall it be. Thank you, precious Father. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed.
Please put your hands together for the Lord. Are you putting your hands together? Let's appreciate the man of God. What we received tonight, praise the Lord. You know, if you go to Harvard Business School or you go for 1 hour, you know, lecture in Harvard, I tell you, it will cost, and they may not even give you up to these depths. And we're putting it together today, tomorrow, and Sunday. Please don't miss it. Even if you come, you don't give offering, that's okay. Just come and be blessed. Amen. The knowledge you are passing to is for you to be blessed, and for you and the people around you. So don't miss it. We cannot overemphasize this. You know, it breaks my heart when, you know, you put things together and you find out that, you know, people don't show up. Or people show up, they are not interested, or they don't have the, you know, the readiness to learn. And these same people, if you put it together outside, they will fly there, stay in the hotel, you know, their time will be, you know, they will spend a lot of time, probably not in a hurry or just to get something. And they may come out and not really get something that is not really deep. So please invite somebody and come tomorrow. We start tomorrow by 10 a.m. 10 a.m. we kick off tomorrow. Please don't miss it and invite somebody. Amen. Pastor Gbenga talked about the book he brought, The Prosperity Mindset and In Pursuit of Greatness. Let's encourage him. You know, one $15, another $20. If you buy the two, $30. $30, you know, will not be too much for you to gain knowledge. Knowledge is power. Amen. You know, I'm reading a book now by the Sheikh of Dubai. You know, he's a Muslim. But what I'm reading in the book is really, really blessing me. Even though he's a Muslim, whatever knowledge I'm gaining there, I will use it for myself and for the church I'm pastoring. And if there's prosperity, nobody will know where it comes from. Amen. But I'm investing in myself to read wide and to be able to get some knowledge. Please buy the truth and sell it not. Please let's encourage, you know, our pastor. Tomorrow 10 a.m. let's be here. On Sunday, Sister Christie called me, you know, and told me that, you know,
she lost the mother-in-law, you know. And yesterday the husband called me and we were talking. You know, so, and Mama has been part of this church. When I started in A Street, I started in Boys and Girls Club. Mama was there. And she passed on to glory on Sunday, Mother's Day in Nigeria. So let's encourage the family. Let's call them. Let's encourage them. I think the service of song is coming up April 22nd. April 22nd. They will let us know more or about that. Let's encourage them. Let's call them. And let's be part of, you know, that family at this crucial time. Let's stand up on our feet as we end the service today. You know, have you been blessed? If you have been blessed, so please don't miss tomorrow and don't miss Sunday. And come early and come, you know, writing something down. And after that, we will take the action. You know, the action is that everybody in this church, this is a wealthy church. Because God is going to, the mindset of prosperity is going to be our mindset in Jesus' name. Now stretch forth your hands towards the man of God. Let's pray for him. We thank you for your servant that you have used. You said the library soul will be made fat. He that watered will be watered. I pray you will water your son in Jesus' name. Take him from glory to glory. Use him for your glory. And Lord, broaden his knowledge in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. We give you all the glory. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Also, please pick the CD of Brother John Opara before you go. It's $10. Let's encourage people in our midst, and the Lord will bless you in Jesus' name. Father, we thank you as we go tonight. We go in your strength and your power. Lord, as you brought us here safely, we pray as we go back to our destination, take us back safely in Jesus' name. We forbid accident. We forbid incidents. Lord, we speak protection on the highway, on the freeway, on the edges, and on the roads in Jesus' name. Lord, we pray we'll get to our destination safely to the praise of your name, in the name of Jesus. As we sleep tonight, Lord, you give it your beloved sleep. Give us restful sleep tonight. We forbid nightmare, bad dream, in the name of Jesus. We pray, oh God, that your protective edge be sure over us and our families in Jesus' name. We pray that we'll sleep soundly and we'll wake up tomorrow soundly to the praise of your name and to the shame of the devil. Father, we thank you. We give you all the glory. In Jesus' matchless name, we have prayed. Let the saints say louder, amen. Amen. Let's share the grace in fellowship. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, his goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Praise the Lord. The Lord bless you. Have a good night. See you tomorrow. The CD is with the ushers. It's $10. Please, let's encourage our brothers. You know, let's get Ndima $10. Let's get the books. The books is, you know, $15, $30. Let's come tomorrow. Tomorrow, 10 a.m. Tomorrow, 10 a.m. As many watching us online, we will receive you here tomorrow. And on Sunday, 10 a.m. And tomorrow, 10 a.m. The Lord bless you. Thank you.